coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer. It is the Tuesday edition of the program, February the 23rd, 2021.
I'm all jacked up on Mountain Dew.
Well, I don't know about you, but I don't think I'm jacked up on Mountain Dew this morning.
You seem happy this morning.
I'm always a happy guy, you know. I'm a very, very, very happy guy.
You sound different in person.
Well, I do. Well, I don't know. I don't know why I would sound any different. But the time right now is 6:08. Mr. Clock, would you verify that, please?
It's now 6:08 a.m.
And the program is officially off and running for a Tuesday. And as Mr. Clock said, the official time is, Mr. Clock, would you please do that one more time for me? There we go. Here we go. Mr. Clock, please.
It's now 6:08 a.m.
Just wanted to make sure that Mr. Clock is fully awake. Good morning, Miss Bonnie, and how are yours this morning?
Good morning, Evan. You know, I almost sent you a text last night.
I would have killed you.
To say that.
Just straightforward. You would have woke me up. That's it. You'd have been done.
Oh, yeah. You got to bed very early, didn't
I went to
you?
Bed at 6:50 last night. And
wow.
No, I'm not serious. I wouldn't have killed you.
Oh, I know.
I just would have screamed a little bit.
I was actually going to write to you that I wanted, you know, I was sick. I was feeling under the weather yesterday with cold symptoms. You know, I even took cold pills yesterday in lieu of allergy medicine, but I knew it was my allergies because they were flaring up all day because of the pollen count.
So you were thinking about not coming in this morning.
I really was.
That's okay. If you can text me if that ever happens and you don't feel well and you're not going to come in to do the morning show, just let me know and I will head up to Fort Pierce. And we'll tell it what to do, and I'll just go up there and do a blended show.
Oh, yeah. You would like to join G and Ray once in a while
I'd hang out with them. Sure.
Yeah.
I would definitely hang out with
them. It was a thing, though, where it's kind of like a weird time to even say you're sick because then people might assume that, oh, well, maybe you have a cold or maybe you have COVID, and then you kind of want to plan your day. Well, maybe if I stay home sick, I should go get tested for COVID. When I knew that wasn't the situation, it was just the pollen count yesterday was very high.
Yeah, you just
got to
be very careful what you say nowadays. I mean, the slightest little thing, like, you know, oh, God, my nose is running. I got the sniffles. Forget it. You've got COVID. That's what everybody's going to start saying.
It's going to assume, right?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Everybody's going to assume. And you know what happens when you assume, don't you? You make a out of you and me.
Yeah.
Let's just say it that way.
Today, for those that do suffer from allergies, if you're feeling a little better, we're at a moderate pollen count today, including the tree pollens and the grass pollens. We are at moderate. I think just yesterday we were at that all-time high, and I saw different people with symptoms. You know, there was like a young girl at work that was even, you know, like taking a nap in her vehicle in between practices.
Oh, wow.
So I think even that heavy pollen and allergy count yesterday was even affecting her.
Oh.
But yeah, it was to the point where it just kind of like made me sick in bed last night, where I got out of bed to drink a lot of water and take cold medicine of all things.
Okay.
It was just a terrible situation.
All right. I got out of here yesterday, and of course, I went to the ballpark.
Yes.
You know, got to play this music because I'm in full Mets mode. As you can see, I have my work clothes on.
I know.
And everything. And boy, a lot of buzz around the stadium. Things are happening. 1 week from today, it's official opening day of spring training games.
Oh, yeah, next week Tuesday.
Yeah, we're playing the Miami Marlins. I cannot wait to get behind that microphone and say good afternoon and welcome to Clover Park for today's game between the visiting Miami Marlins and the homestanding New York Mets. Man, I cannot wait to say that.
Yeah, that's the way you do it, Evan. And the crowd, I bet, can't wait to hear you.
Yeah.
And I hear
I'm so excited.
Being sold out, too. It's,
it's pretty
heavy
much,
tickets.
Yeah, all the games are, from what I understand, all the games are sold out. And the reason they're sold out is because they're only letting a quarter capacity into the stadium for safety purposes.
Yeah.
So it's about 1,200 people. Now, you can go on aftermarket sites that are selling these tickets. I don't condone them doing that. I don't. I think that's awful that they're doing this. They're selling tickets that you would pay $20, $25 for, starting at $75 to $100.
And people would pay that, are easily paying
that?
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's websites. I'm not going to say the websites because I don't want to plug the websites because I don't condone what they're doing. But people are taking their season tickets and they're putting them on the certain websites. And like, for instance, to sit behind home plate would normally cost you $35, $40. They're selling these things for $300, $400, $500.
Wow. And they're making a little bit of a profit.
A little? That's an understatement, for God's sakes.
Well, let them ride with it, right? I know you don't condone it.
No, I don't.
But, you know,
it's awful.
If they're getting rid of the tickets, maybe that they're not going to use.
Well, they should just sell them at face value, what they paid for them. This is COVID, for God's sakes. People want to get out. They want to get out of the house. They want to go to a ball game. And they can't go to a ball game because somebody's selling these tickets for $300, $400, $500.
And only the rich can go. It kind of reminds me of when COVID began and people were hoarding the toilet paper, and some were even selling the toilet paper spools on eBay.
Mm-hmm.
And like jacking up the price so they could
make
profits.
Yeah, well, eBay took those sites right down real quick.
Yeah.
They were taking that stuff down. But, man, when I saw, I went on the website and I was like, you got to be kidding me. Oh, my gosh.
So now I bet you're going to be like, from your beautiful view of where you're at, are you going to kind of look for the people in
these
seats?
Well, I don't know who they are. I won't know who they are. I don't know if they're legit season ticket holders or if they're the people that spent the $300, $400, $500 that have a whole lot of money to spend and just POA it.
Who knows?
And stuff like this.
Who knows, right?
So, but it is what it is. But I do have friends that that purchase season tickets that actually go to the games. They don't sell their season tickets. And I would think that more so now with COVID and everything, that fans, they want to get out of the house. They want some semblance of normality again and go to a ball game and just don't sell your tickets.
I wonder if Chris Christie is going to be back at our ball games this season.
You know, I don't know because I have actually ridden in the elevator with him before.
Yeah, you said that. You told me that before.
I got on the elevator with him before. We had a little slight conversation. He went up to the owner's suite. And very nice man.
Yeah.
Very, very nice man.
My Gary knows his aunt in town of Governor Christie.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah, super nice guy. He's a huge Mets fan, so he does come in town. I mean, you know, we're known to have celebrities at the games from time to time. There's a whole lot of stuff.
You know, I could be wrong. I could swear I'm wrong. But there was one time I was walking through the Walmart in St. Lucie West.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know why she would even be in Walmart. I just know that she's from St. Lucie West and she grew up there.
Right.
I could have sworn that I saw one Megan Fox one day.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you know, anything's possible.
I mean, it looked like her. She was glamorous, very tall, very beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought it was her. I mean, I could be wrong. And it looked like she appeared to be with some sort of a baseball player, too.
Oh.
Yeah. So I don't know.
You know, anything's possible.
Like dating a baseball player from there at one time. I'm not sure. This was several years ago, but it was, right down here in St. Lucie West at the Walmart.
I just realized I had this on my wrist. You know what this is that I'm holding?
It looks like a pink thing for breast cancer awareness.
Well, no. It's but great thought, though. This is what we have to wear at the stadium. Every day we get a new one. I didn't take the fact. I should. There. Okay. It's off now. So every day we get one of these when we check into the stadium. They have a different color, I think, for every day. And what it is, you get your temperature taken, and then you read this one sheet, and you have to adhere to, you know, have you been sick? Have you been around anybody that's had COVID, this, that, and the other? And then you get a wristband, and then you go in, and then you're all clear and ready to go.
It shows that you're clear. Now, today, when you go, you will get a brand new one?
I'll get a brand new one. Yeah. I get my temperature taken every single day I go to the stadium. And, you know, and that's really about it. They're using a lot of safety protocols. I have never seen a place more safe than Clover Park.
That's
honestly
great.
It's amazing. They have the seats all strapped up. So you can't sit on top of other people. It's like there's a row strapped, then there's two rows There's a cup, you know, there's like two or three rows strapped. Then there's an open row. Then there's another couple of rows strapped. So it's you won't be within 6 feet of anybody unless you're with the person that you bought the tickets with in what's called a pod.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way they're selling the tickets.
Are they sanitizing the seats there too every afternoon? Like sanitizing and sanitizing
again? Yeah, everything.
Again?
They have a cleaning crew come in after every game and they'll sweep the whole entire stadium. And I don't literally mean sweep with a broom. They'll sweep the whole stadium. So everything is going to be wiped down. It's going to be sanitized. Everything is touchless. When you purchase items at the concession stands, it's all touchless.
Okay.
You just tap your card. You don't even have to sign anything.
Wow.
It's really amazing. The technology is unreal, and they've really gone above and beyond, in my humble opinion, at Clover Park to make things very, very safe for the fans for this year for spring training.
Got to take those safety measures.
God only knows the fans need to get out.
They do.
You know, they had baseball season last year at Citi Field, but there were no fans there. They had the cutouts.
Yeah, what good is it, like, without fans? I mean,
yeah.
We even have, like, a story coming in our sports this morning, mm-hmm. like in the NFL, where because they had a low amount of fans with
right.
the fan base, that
right.
the home games for NFL football this year, mm-hmm. they took several more losses than they had in the past.
Well, of course, all the teams lost yeah. revenue. There was enormous amounts of money that was lost this year in all the sports, in baseball, in football, basketball, soccer, tennis. I mean, it's upwards in the billions of dollars.
And
how much money
trickled down to, like, everybody. Every
yeah.
certain person
yeah.
that works for sports or has something to do with
yep.
making a monetary for sports. Mm-hmm. It really affected everyone.
I mean, could you imagine, Bonnie, in Tampa, Florida, where they only allowed so many people into the Super Bowl, the millions of dollars mm-hmm. that was lost from being pumped into the economy in Tampa this year.
Yeah, and the powers that be with the NFL had stated mm-hmm. that they might even want Tampa Bay to host it again because they felt like, wow,
well,
yeah, Tampa
successful.
Bay was able to host it, but they lost out on revenue because
yeah.
of COVID.
Right.
So they brought up the base of, hey, why, maybe they should host it again in the future because it wasn't really fair this time.
Exactly. And then there's another big event that's coming up in Tampa in April. It's called WrestleMania. It's the WWE's Super Bowl of Wrestling. And they usually, and it's supposed to be in Tampa, they usually would have an upwards of 80,000 people in that stadium.
Holy man.
For
and the
WrestleMania.
Stadium alone. Huh?
Yeah, for WrestleMania.
That's got to be one huge stadium out there.
Well,
oh,
it's
yeah,
where the Bucks play.
And that's where I think, it seems to me, my stepkids went out there to see John Cena
mm-hmm.
at one time
yep,
in Tampa.
They wouldn't have seen him in the Bucks stadium. They
okay.
would have seen him probably at the Amalie Arena, you know, one of the smaller venues up there. But last year, WrestleMania was supposed to be at the stadium in Tampa, and it got canceled because of COVID. So this year, WrestleMania is going to be held at that stadium,
mm-hmm.
but they're going to have a limited amount of fans, probably about 20,000. Kind of like the Super Bowl. It's going to be on the same premise as the Super Bowl because they watched very intently of how successful the Super Bowl was, and you heard no news come out of the Super Bowl about, you know, hundreds of people catching COVID going to the Super Bowl. So obviously they did it right in Tampa at the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
So WrestleMania is going to follow that same protocol.
You got to. You almost really have to. Or else it could be like bad news next year and, you know, they could have a bad rep when they hold it
yeah.
again.
Yeah, definitely so. It is now 6:21 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for news. Let's head over to the news desk where Bonnie has the morning headlines. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. As the U.S. surpassed 500,000 coronavirus-related deaths on Monday, President Joe Biden directed that the U.S. flag be flown at half-staff through sundown Friday. The rate of coronavirus deaths has increased in recent months. Half of the 500,000 deaths have occurred in the last 3 months. From the White House, Biden addressed the nation on Monday. Biden then joined his wife, Jill Biden, along with Vice President Kamala Harris and her husband, Doug Emhoff, for a moment of silence outside the White House. Earlier on Monday, the National Cathedral rang 500 church bells, one for every 1,000 Americans who died from the coronavirus since early last year. A top state official and the mayor of one of Florida's largest cities say they will disregard Governor Ron DeSantis's order to lower flags to half staff in honor of the late talk show host Rush Limbaugh.
State Agriculture Commissioner Nikki Fried says lowering the flag to half staff is a sacred honor that pays respect to those she calls fallen heroes and patriots. As a result, she's ordering all state offices under her direction to ignore the governor's order, saying the state will not celebrate hate speech, bigotry, and division. Meanwhile, St. Pete Mayor Rick Kreisman says he won't lower the flag for Limbaugh either, saying the city won't honor racism, homophobia, or anything else he's spewed over the years. Kreisman says the city will, however, honor the life of Pinellas County Sheriff's Deputy Michael Magley, who was killed in the line of duty last week. I'm Reed Shepard.
A Treasure Coast man is proving he's never too late to chase a dream. WPTV's Megan McRoberts has this story.
Thank you for your patience.
In the comfort of his Stewart home, 88-year-old Felix Taborda, with his wife Laura by his side.
So I'm going to ask you to please raise your right hand.
Takes his oath of allegiance to become a United States citizen.
That I will support.
A moment nearly a decade in the making. Felix and Laura flew to the United States in 2013 upon the pleading of their children living in the U.S., fleeing Venezuela during a time of violent political unrest.
We decided to stay here, to live here, and our country is very, very hard to live in the condition the government they have right now.
Seeking safety and a better life. Despite both being well-educated with important jobs, Felix, a college professor with a Ph.D.
The salary is $6 per month.
Felix knows the United States is still a beacon of hope for many immigrants like him, wanting to call their home a place with shared values.
I like democracy.
Freedom.
When a social worker with Treasure Coast Hospice learned that even at his late age, Felix still had set his sights on citizenship, she helped write letters, submit medical documents, helping secure Felix an unusual chance to take a citizenship test at home, as he is in hospice care with stage 4 colon cancer.
So help me God.
Yeah.
Help me God.
Okay, congratulations.
To now sharing citizenship with his wife, who took her oath last year.
Okay, awesome.
Giving them comfort they'll spend the rest of their years together with family and no threat of separation.
We are all together.
Megan McRoberts, WPTV, News Channel 5.
Ford Motor Company has issued a safety compliance recall for 79,017 vehicles in the United States for windshield adhesion. Ford says the affected vehicles do not comply with federal motor vehicle safety standards. The front windshields are inadequately bonded to the vehicle body structure. Ford says in the event of a crash, the windshield may not adequately stay in place, increasing the risk of injury. The recall affects 79,017 vehicles in the U.S. and federal territories. It includes a 2021 Ford F-150. The vehicles that were built at Dearborn Truck Plant from October 27, 2020 to February 3, 2021, and the 2021 Ford Super Duty vehicles that were built at Kentucky Truck Plant from October 13, 2020 to January 23, 2021. Ford says it is not aware of any accidents or injuries related to this condition. Owner notifications will begin the week of April 6. Dealers will remove and reinstall the windshield using standard service procedures. And lastly, President Joe Biden is reportedly considering former U.S. Senator Bill Nelson of Florida to lead NASA. The former head of the space agency, Jim Bridenstine, stepped down as Biden took office. In the NBA, the Miami Heat topped the Thunder 108-94 at Oklahoma City. The Orlando Magic aim for a fourth straight win tonight. Go Magic! When they host the Detroit Pistons. Now our news time is 6:26. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24/7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, say habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
It's 6:27 the time right now on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, this morning on the Turnpike southbound up in Vero Beach, we are seeing a vehicle crash with injuries, and the left lane is blocked due to this accident. Now, this is southbound on the Turnpike up that way. Those heading northbound having to go up there this morning, it doesn't look like you're going to find any tie-ups. Back here in Martin County, we're looking at a good ride. US 1 looking good, and our major highways right here okay at the moment, too. There's your latest look at traffic. Port St. Lucie, 69 degrees. In Churchill, Canada, a whopping cold 16 below zero temperature. Here's our weather at WPTV.
Happy Tuesday sunshine. Waking up this morning to temperatures in the mid-60s. Some isolated rainfall for the morning drive, then clearing conditions through this afternoon with highs in the mid-70s. Tonight, cooler weather makes a return, lows in the upper 50s, mostly clear skies and some patchy fog. Tomorrow, highs in the mid-70s, mostly sunny skies and a 20% chance for late-day showers. Wednesday into the end of the work week, morning lows in the mid-60s, highs in the low 80s, plenty of sunshine and low rain chances. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Just imagine. Imagine finding a doctor who listens. Imagine a doctor who cares, who takes time to understand you and your lifestyle better. Imagine an entire care team dedicating to helping you live your best life. You don't have to imagine. WellMed is redefining aging with our unique approach to care designed by physicians to help you stay as healthy as possible. Learn more about our recognized model of care at discoverwellmed.com.
So, have you heard this one? A priest and a rabbi come into this radio station. Really, it's a priest and a rabbi right here, Friday mornings beginning at 9, here on WSTU AM 1450. Bring your questions and join their lively conversation with Father Christian from St. Mary's Episcopal Church and Rabbi Matt Durbin from the Temple Beit Hayim. It's a priest and a rabbi, Friday mornings at 9 here on WSTU.
Are you looking for your dream home on the Treasure Coast? I am Eileen Simons, a licensed realtor with eXp Realty. My team and I can help you find your dream home. I bring 20 plus years experience in the residential real estate market, helping both buyers and sellers achieve their dreams. Call me at 772-200-5105 or visit our website at mydreamhomeusa.com.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to wstumorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go Show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
You think you know me?
So if that song sounds familiar to you, that's WWE Superstar Edge, who has officially announced who he's going to be challenging at WrestleMania for the World Heavyweight Championship, going to be going against Roman Reigns. Made that announcement over the weekend, so it's going to be a definitely a star-studded event. WrestleMania, of course, happening in the month of April, so make sure and go to the WWE Network and you can watch WrestleMania without a doubt. So without further ado, let's do some viral videos. So Bonnie, I only have one viral video this morning. This is hilarious. This one takes the cake. Did you know that you could make fart sounds by blowing into the straw of a plastic cup?
I'm sure you could. I mean, I've never tried it before, but now that you think of it, the science with it and everything.
Well, there's a guy who uses that valuable skill to prank people in stores.
In the stores.
Okay. He has his back to them while making the sound, and a buddy films the look on their faces.
That's great.
This is hilarious. Let's listen. Oh, wait. I had the wrong volume up. Here we go. Let me play that again. Hold on, because I had the wrong volume up, and it just, you have to hear the thing all the way from the beginning. So here we go. Okay, he's in the store.
That one sounded like a dog growl.
Yeah.
Wow.
The guy said, wow. Here's another one.
Are you serious?
Sorry.
And then he goes, sorry.
But a lady even questioned it.
You gotta let him go sometimes.
Are you serious? She goes.
Yeah.
Doesn't she know that that's a human form of sometimes you can't help it? But it bothered her so bad, she had to question it? Wow.
She questioned it. If it was real.
Oh. You know, that reminds me of something the Impractical Jokers would do.
I have to ask you a question.
Okay.
I have to ask you this. Have you ever been in the store and it just accidentally slipped?
No.
Never?
Not in the store. No.
Or out public? Anywhere? Is it ever? It had to slip once in your lifetime. It has to have.
You know, not that I recall.
Really?
No, and not recently. I mean, not recently anyway, and nothing really etched in my memory. I think it would be most embarrassing if, like, I was standing in line at the movie theater, you know, mm-hmm. how you got to stand outside and wait in line for your ticket.
Right.
If one would slip right there.
You're just waiting for your ticket, and all of a sudden... And you just look around, like, just nonchalantly, like nothing happened.
Yeah.
Wow. I'll admit it's happened to me.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, when you were at the store?
Oh, yeah.
Even, and,
oh, yeah.
And
at the store?
People look, and did you get
at a wedding.
At a wedding.
It's great at a wedding because, see, here's the thing. This is the best part. The music is so loud. Nobody can hear anything.
You think it's going to flood it, right?
Right. It just floods it out. And then you just, never mind. I could tell you some tall stories. I don't want to get into that whole topic.
Wow.
Yeah.
And then do people, like, did anybody ever say anything to you like the lady just did in the video?
Well,
like,
no, because it depends where you are. It depends where you are. But I've had people look at me just, like, really strange.
Yeah.
You know, they've looked at me like, okay, you really did that in public? I'm like, well, you know, we're all human. You know, we all have to make things happen.
Yeah, so, you most certainly are human.
I looked at one lady once and I said, I had beans last night for dinner. What do you want?
Yeah, what are you going to do about it? Evan, did you see the video this morning, too, of that large Victorian house that they were moving
in San Francisco? That was so cool.
That was impressive.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, you see this house being moved down their city streets.
Yeah.
And I think to move that, they had to spend like $400,000 to move it just like a quarter
six
of a
blocks,
mile.
Six blocks.
Yeah.
It was crazy. The amount of money they spent just to move this thing, six blocks. But, you know, could you imagine you go to bed one night and, you know, you went out and you went drinking, you had a few drinks, and you wake up and you go downstairs from your apartment building.
Right.
And you go to get the paper at the corner store. And here's this house coming down the street at you.
Yeah.
And you're like, holy crap.
You'd be
what's
thinking,
going on?
Am I seeing something? You would feel like you're in a Tim Burton movie or something.
Yeah,
seeing this.
You're like, you'd probably be thinking you're still in a drunken stupor.
Yes.
From the night before.
But it looks like the person moving that house is going to open it to rent different rooms out in it.
Yeah.
It is awfully huge, but man, how to maneuver a huge thing like that.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yes.
That's crazy. I found a story, Bonnie. I want to talk a little bit about food this morning that talks about what your snacks reveal about you.
Oh, boy.
Okay, what you eat, what your snacks reveal about you as a person. The snack food that you crave can tell the world all about you. Now, there's a gentleman by the name of Dr. Alan Hirsch of the Smell and Taste Treatment and Research Foundation in Chicago, Illinois, who spent 8 years studying 800 volunteers.
Oh.
And he discovered a revealing link between food preferences and personality traits in his test subjects. Now, take a look at this mouth-watering selection of goodies and choose the one that makes your tummy tingle, okay?
Sure.
So we'll start with pretzels, okay? If you eat pretzels, you're a live wire who's bursting with energy and always ready to party with your friends. You're also a ball of fire at work, juggling a variety of tasks effortlessly, and sometimes your family and friends may have a tough time keeping up with you.
Oh, yeah. They say those that enjoy pretzels, too, mm-hmm. enjoy a lot of beer because
yeah.
you almost get thirsty for the beer following
right.
the pretzels.
Right. Now, are you a pretzel kind of girl?
I'm not.
Okay. All right. So you're not a fiery little firecracker.
I've never even had a soft pretzel, and Gary's been wanting
oh,
me to try.
Oh, my God.
One.
Are you serious? Seriously. You have never had a soft pretzel?
Never in my life have I had one. Yeah.
What planet are you on?
And I don't like pretzels, so I never
Oh, you have no idea what you're missing.
That's what he tells me too, Evan. And
wow.
I know I should. And
man, a pretzel with some mustard on it
yeah, that's
is
exactly
decadence.
What he said. And then I go, can I put cheese on it? He goes,
cheese
you can put
whiz.
Cheese?
Yeah, the little squirt cheese
Ooh, yeah.
on a pretzel.
That would be good, I bet.
You need to go to the grocery store today and go buy yourself a yeah. box of frozen pretzels. You put them in the oven and make one, and then it comes out, Bonnie, you're going to thank me forever and thank your boyfriend
okay.
forever.
Do they still have that soft pretzel place, too, in the mall?
Yeah, Auntie...
Auntie Anne's or
Auntie,
something?
I forget what it's called.
Aunt's or Annie's?
Yeah, Aunt Annie's. Yes, yeah. Aunt Annie's. If you go there and get a pretzel, that's real decadence.
Decadence, okay.
But you have to get the pretzel that's dipped in the cinnamon.
Oh, boy. Okay.
That is a good pretzel.
That sounds like a Cinnabon.
I'm telling you, it is so good.
All right.
All right. Now, if you eat potato chips, they say that you're an aggressive and an opinionated person who seldom takes no for an answer. Being so tenacious can make you a bit of a pain in the neck to your friends and loved ones, but you can also be counted on to see projects through to the very, very end if you eat potato chips.
Wow.
That's mm-hmm. your personality there. Now, if you eat beef jerky,
yes.
you are a gregarious person who never met a stranger before. Your outgoing personality assures you a large circle of friends who never consider an outgoing without consider an outing without you in tow. Your people skills also help you achieve your goals on the job. Now, have you ever eaten beef jerky before?
I wonder if that includes a Slim Jim, because
yeah.
I'm more apt to eat Slim Jims
yeah.
than a tough, like a you know, tough binding
yeah.
beef jerky.
Yeah, definitely. A Slim Jim would be considered a beef jerky. Now, if you eat cheese curls or cheese puffs, okay, you're pretty much classified as a straight shooter with high morals, okay? You believe honesty in relationships is a must, and you don't waste time on people who play fast and lose with the truth. Friends experiencing a crisis of conscience turn to you for counseling if you eat cheese curls or cheese puffs.
Mm-hmm. Do you eat a lot of those,
no.
Evan? Would you
no.
consider yourself...
No, I'm not a cheese puff kind of a guy.
That's usually not my go-to. I mean, I
yeah.
like them. I'll eat that more mm-hmm. than I'm likely to eat a pretzel. And
right.
I think the big... bowl of them and, you know, mm-hmm. the big tubs of them look real pretty
right.
in the store with those big puff balls inside.
Now, if you eat tortilla chips, you are definitely obsessed with perfection in every aspect of your life. Okay? This makes you a super achiever, but you may have difficulty relating to others because they don't always meet your high standards. You'll be happier if you learn to be flexible.
Mm.
Now, I don't eat tortilla chips, but dang it, I am obsessed with perfection.
Yeah, anyway.
I am a major perfectionist.
Right, right. So which one of these fast foods or these maybe junk foods on the list are you? Which one
I
is
would
your go-to?
I would say pretzels.
Oh, the pretzel.
Yeah, because I'm bursting with energy.
Yeah.
All the time. What about you, Bonnie?
I would be the potato chips.
So you're aggressive and opinionated.
The chips and the nachos would be my thing.
All right,
so that
means you're aggressive and opinionated. So you seldom take no for an answer. You just barrel right through.
I don't know. I try to sit back and think before I do the barreling through, though.
Okay.
So I don't know if all of this is true. Certainly some of those traits would ascertain to me.
Okay. All right. Now, with that said, I also have a list of 10 things that you'll never do again because of the pandemic.
Oh.
Okay, this is a pretty interesting list. Okay, 10 things you will never do again because of the pandemic. Coming in at number 10 is using somebody else's deodorant. Have you ever run out of deodorant and used Gary's?
Yes, I have.
Okay, I've never used Rachel's, but Rachel's used mine.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a good one. All right, coming in at number 9, sharing bags of chips or other snacks with someone you don't live with.
Yeah, that's okay. Gross right now.
That's because of the pandemic.
I mean, and if I do share chips mm-hmm. at work, I like to pour some on their plate.
Right, exactly.
I don't want to be digging out of the same bag, man.
Coming in at number 8, leaving the house without hand sanitizer.
Right.
Leaving the house without hand sanitizer. These are 10 things you'll never do again because of the pandemic. Coming in at number 7, standing really close to people in line. Okay,
mm-hmm.
These are all normal things we do now, and that's normal now.
It has become normal.
Yes,
and
it's
even
new
if
normal.
This thing goes away,
yep.
I think people are still going to tend to do use that
six foot yep.
rule.
Coming in at number 6, using a friend's makeup. Using a friend's makeup. You'll never do that again.
Mm-hmm.
Coming in at number 5, borrowing. Now, this is just gross.
What is
borrowing somebody else's bathing suit?
That is.
That's just gross.
Why would, you can go out and buy your own. I mean, I paid $16 for a brand new one.
Yeah.
Just the other day.
Just go buy one.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Coming in at number 4. Yeah, this one was going around all over the place before the pandemic. Making out with a stranger at the bar. You know how you go to a bar and you meet a chick or a guy and you just kind of click and all of a sudden you just start sucking face right at the bar. Oh, that's no longer going to happen.
Well, I'm sure you're still going to see it because people are still out there drinking shots of tequila. You know that's not going to change.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to rule it out completely.
Yeah.
You're going to find one or two that are here and there, very, very wasted and feeling high and, and in love.
So. Coming in at number 3, trying out food samples at the store. You know those little kiosks where they have people cooking the little samples?
See, now that's
not going to happen.
I'll still do that.
Really?
I don't mind that.
You would do that?
Yeah, if I'm at a store and I'm feeling hungry. I mean, I know they got the gloves on. They always wear that little hat.
Okay.
Around their head, the shower cap.
All right.
I'll go get a little sampling.
Coming in at number 2, taking a bite out of someone else's sandwich.
That's just disgusting.
Yeah.
That's right up there with putting your hands in the same bag of potato chips.
Yeah, exactly.
Uh-uh.
Yeah, that's like, because there'll be like slobber on the sandwich.
Yeah, these are some of the worst
now,
on
would
the
you,
list.
Now, would you take a bite out of Gary's sandwich?
No.
No?
I don't even do that.
Okay.
No, in fact, I had our roast beef sandwiches last night, which he left at home yesterday.
Go ahead, throw him under the bus.
He was supposed
Wait a minute, hold on, stop there. Let me just read number 1, and then you can continue throwing Gary under the bus. Okay. And coming in at number 1 on the top 10 things you'll never do because of the pandemic, and that's sharing chapstick.
Oh, that's gross, too. Yeah. That and sticking your finger into somebody else's Carmex, when you got that Carmex jar.
Yes.
That's definitely going to be a no right now,
yes.
too.
Or double dipping a celery stick is another one.
No.
Right? You dip it, you take a bite, and then you dip it again.
Yes.
Yeah, that's like double dipping.
Yeah, that's why it's good that, people kind of refrained from the parties this year, and the Super Bowl parties.
Yeah.
A lot of people had parties
of their own. It's time now for a segment that we're adding to the program. It's a brand new segment. It's called Let's Throw Gary Under the Bus.
Oh, no.
Bonnie, if you'll tell us about that, please.
Well, I made these. I'm sure every woman has experienced it,
uh-huh.
or maybe fella, too.
Right.
But, when, you work at the same place and
mm-hmm.
you make these wonderful roast beef and cheddar cheese sandwiches,
right.
and the roast beef is so robust.
It's rare. I love my roast beef mooing.
Oh,
it's got to move.
Yeah, this
right?
was kind of like a medium rare, but okay. it was deli fresh.
Okay.
You know?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And then the bread okay. was oh so soft and white,
right.
soft,
okay.
new fresh bread, and okay. I have these sandwiches ready to go, okay. and he forgot to bring them to work
so
yesterday.
So you took all the time and effort and love and TLC yeah. to make these things, and he walks out of the house and leaves them sitting in the fridge.
Yep. But so
oh, shame on him.
So we had them for like a late lunch yesterday when we got home, so they didn't go to waste.
Okay.
But yeah, what I was going to get into, too, was like no way will I even take a bite out of his sandwich.
Okay.
In fact, I cut them into,
okay.
you know, little halves, mm-hmm. or I leave his V and let him do it.
Gotcha. So I have a question
for
you.
There's no biting out of one another's.
Where's Gary? He was supposed to be here this morning.
He was sleeping so well
right?
this morning.
He
you
was
know?
Supposed to be here. He said he was coming in Tuesday morning to be with us. And I looked so forward to him being here.
Thank you.
And,
yeah.
And all of a sudden, I was like let down. It was the big letdown.
You know, he was sleeping too well, and
I don't care. I would have woke his little behind right up.
I didn't have the heart to bother him this
Man,
morning.
You're just too nice.
Like, you need your sleep, babe.
Wow. you're just too nice. Man. Yeah. Wake up, Gary. 6:48 right now. The Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for news, all brought to you by my good friend, Hawk Levy, at St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. Make sure and stop by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin for the best deals in town. Here's Bonnie with the headlines.
Thanks, Evan. The pace of vaccine distribution is picking up across Florida, but vaccine hesitancy continues to be a problem, especially among minority communities. Dr. Ulrich Simmons of Advent Health, himself African American, understands that concern.
Heard a lot of things around the trust of the community, particularly those who are African American and Latinx, who have longstanding memories of atrocities that have been committed.
But Dr. Simmons says the vaccine is safe and effective, and you're putting your life in danger each day you hesitate to get vaccinated. Gas prices in Florida are up 15 cents this week compared to last, the highest they've been in over a year.
There's a good chance that we could even see another hike this week of a few cents, maybe even up to 5 cents. It's hard to say.
AAA's Mark Jenkins, that's because of refinery outages in Texas caused by the winter freeze. As the U.S. surpassed 500,000 coronavirus-related deaths on Monday, President Joe Biden directed that the U.S. flag be flown at half-staff through sundown Friday. The rate of coronavirus deaths has increased in recent months. Half of the 500,000 deaths have occurred in the last 3 months. From the White House, Biden addressed the nation on Monday. Biden then joined his wife, Jill Biden, along with Vice President Kamala Harris and her husband, Doug Emhoff, for a moment of silence outside the White House. Earlier on Monday, the National Cathedral rang 500 church bells, one for every 1,000 Americans who died from coronavirus since early last year. SpaceX is planning to launch its first all-civilian flight this fall, and a 29-year-old woman who beat cancer as a kid just got a free ticket. Her name is Haley Arsenault. She was a patient at St. Jude's 2 decades ago and now works there as a physician assistant. A billionaire named Jared Isaacman is paying for her seat. And you could also win one by donating at least $10 to St. Jude's by this Sunday. Well, lastly, the main mansion that actor John Travolta shared with his late wife, actor Kelly Preston, has been put up for sale. The 67-year-old star of Grease and Saturday Night Fever recently listed the home on Islesboro, an island off the coast of Maine, for $5 million, according to the Portland Press Herald. The couple bought the home in 1991 as newlyweds and turned it from a very dark and somber house into a bright family home for their son-to-be-born son, Jet, according to a 1999 feature in the Architectural Digest. Preston, who had roles alongside Tom Cruise and Jerry Maguire and Arnold Schwarzenegger in Twins, died last year after a 2-year battle with breast cancer. She was 57. FAU freshman and Jensen Beach High School alum Caleb Pendleton hit 2 grand slams. Reporter Tyree Smith has the story.
And Sue. Pendleton, long drive, deep left field, going back to the wall, looking at it fly away is Jostin.
Back to the plate with the bases littered again. Oh my gosh. He has done it. Two grand slams in one inning.
Tyree Smith here with Jensen Beach alum and FAU freshman Caleb Pendleton. Caleb, coming out of Jensen Beach, I'm sure you, among others, had expected you to do great things for this Owl team, but did you expect it to come this quickly?
Not at all. I honestly didn't know that I was playing last night until I got to the field. And so after I saw that, I was a little nervous all the time, and all my all the teammates knew that I was nervous. And then we actually had to light the lights. Half of our lights were out. So we were thinking about not even playing the game, getting the lights on. And so I can't tell you how many times I walked from the bullpen back to the dugout, just pacing back and forth, all nervous. And then after the first at-bat, everyone's like, I told you, like, you'll be fine.
And you were more than fine. You were fantastic. Talk about your mindset going up to bat last night when the bases were loaded moments before you hit the first grand slam.
First, when I was going up there with the bases loaded, and I wasn't trying to do too much. I just wanted to put the ball in play. And my first two swings, I kind of chased and didn't have the best swing. So I just kind of locked it in, choked up a little bit with two strikes. And I saw a curveball out of his hand. And I kind of just stayed on it and ended up hitting it. And as I was running to first base, I was kind of like saying to myself, get out ball, get out ball. And it kind of was surreal running around first base when it actually finally went out. So,
what were some of the things coaches and teammates were telling you after you walked into the dugout?
Honestly, I don't really remember much that they were saying. It was kind of crazy. Everyone was pushing me around, jumping and stuff. So it's kind of hard to remember anything that was said. It was kind of a really surreal moment.
But then your second at-bat came up. And what was your plan this time around?
Second at-bat, I went up there and I was like, I don't want to do too much. I already hit one, so just don't look like I'm trying to hit a home run. And I knew that the first time I hit a curveball out and I was looking fastball, so they were throwing me a fastball and throwing me a belt high fastball. And as soon as I hit it, unlike the first one, I knew it was gone instantly. And it really didn't hit me that I hit two grand slams in the same inning until I got back in the dugout and was sitting there. The reaction was kind of different from the dugout. They were all kind of like shocked. So it was just like a really cool experience.
Going forward, as the season is really just getting started, what do you feel you need to work on in order to help the FAU team succeed?
This season, I just want to just help the team. I know I'm not going to be the starter this year. Nick Tony is a really good catcher, and he's helped me a lot in just growing as a player and being more mature. So just playing my role when it's time to play my role is going to be the most important thing for me.
Well, our news time is 6:54. Weather and traffic together will be next.
I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiance means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
.656 the time on the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Waterway Dermatology. Dr. Ryan Schering, located at 1050 Monterey Road in Stuart, bringing personalized health care back to dermatology the Waterway. Bonnie?
Well, there is an accident. It's to the north of us. It's on the turnpike southbound in Vero Beach at mile marker 175. That left lane is blocked in that area southbound on the turnpike. Right here in Martin County and looking at areas of St. Lucie County, it's looking like a good ride right now. No tie-ups. There's your latest look at traffic. It's 69, partly cloudy here in Stuart. And in Napier, New Zealand, a clear sky in 65. Here's our weather at WPTV.
Happy Tuesday, sunshine. Waking up this morning to temperatures in the mid-60s. Some isolated rainfall for the morning drive, then clearing conditions through this afternoon with highs in the mid-70s.
Tonight, cooler weather makes a return, lows in the upper 50s, mostly clear skies and some patchy fog. Tomorrow, highs in the mid-70s, mostly sunny skies and a 20% chance for late-day showers. Wednesday into the end of the work week, morning lows in the mid-60s, highs in the low 80s, plenty of sunshine and low rain chances.
Dermatology is now open in Stewart, a new independently owned dermatology practice with Dr. Ryan Shuring, board certified for your medical or cosmetic skincare needs. Office hours 9 to 5 Monday through Saturday with extended hours from 9 to 7 on Thursdays. Serving Martin and St. Lucie counties in the Monterey Triangle Building, US 1 and Monterey Road, Stewart Waterway Dermatology. Bringing personalized health care back to dermatology the waterway. Book a consultation at waterwayderm.com or call 561-926-6150 for Waterway Dermatology.
No hype, just facts. I'm Casey, and I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show at my new time, Wednesdays at 10 a.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It is a fun and interesting hour beginning at 10 a.m. every Wednesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at The Casey Ingram Show.
It's only here but once a year. It's Girl Scout cookie season. Once per year for over 108 years. Girl Scouts all over the USA sell cookies. The sale is just 3.5 weeks long, so buy them while you can. Sale ends March 21st.
Not only are Girl Scout cookies delicious, but by buying Girl Scout cookies, you're supporting local community projects. Last year alone, we made Christmas cards for isolated seniors, we put hygiene kits together for homeless veterans, we gave doggy baths at a local rescue, and we put Christmas stockings together for hundreds of foster kids. We also thanked our local hometown heroes with cookies and cards.
Our troop will be hosting a drive-through cookie booth at the First Congregational Church of God in Port St. Lucie, 4 days a week throughout the sale. But not to worry, you can find a cookie booth by just downloading our Cookie Finder app.
So what can a Girl Scout cookie do?
So much more than what you can see. Buy Girl Scout cookies.
Florida real estate is hot. Now's a great time to find your dream home. I am Eileen Simons, realtor with eXp Realty. Join me for My Dream Home every Monday morning at 10 a.m. on WPSL and WSTU. We'll talk about real estate, interview guest experts, have featured listings, and a featured community each week. That's My Dream Home radio show, Mondays at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU, and Alexa and Google Home on TuneIn.
You are listening to WSTU, Stewart, Jupiter, and Indiantown, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Hey, Anthony, Fox News, 500,000 deaths across America.
While we've been fighting this pandemic for so long, we have to resist becoming numb to the sorrow.
President Biden at a White House ceremony with a moment of silence and candle lighting.
Let this not be a story of how far we fell, but of how far we climb back up.
He again urged us to keep wearing the masks, keep a social distancing, and get a COVID vaccine when we can. Johnson & Johnson, which is hoping for FDA approval soon for its one-dose version, says it could have 20 million vaccine shots ready in the U.S. by the end of next month. A month and a half after the deadly Capitol attack and following the Trump impeachment acquittal, the first hearing into the riot is this morning in the Senate. Fox's Rachel Sutherland has more live.
Dave, the former sergeants-at-arms for the House and Senate, who both resigned after the attack, will testify, along with former Capitol Police Chief Stephen Sund and acting D.C. Police Chief Robert Conte. Watch for lawmakers on two Senate committees to ask tough questions. How much did law enforcement know ahead of the riot? And why wasn't the Capitol more prepared for an attack that was being planned online? The hearings come as Congress considers legislation to set up a bipartisan, independent commission to investigate the riot. Dave?
And Rachel, Merrick Garland told senators if he's confirmed as attorney general, he'll supervise the riot prosecutions.
FBI Director Wray has indicated that the threat of domestic terrorism and particularly of white supremacist extremists is his number one concern in this area.
Garland's hearing will continue today, and two other Biden nominees have hearings also for Interior Secretary, Health and Human Services Secretary. The snow and ice is gone in Texas, but the problems aren't.
Well, no water because our pipe's broke and we can't get a plumber just yet. And the plumber has come out, but there's no parts.
She and many other Texans still without running water. Same for thousands in Louisiana and Mississippi. America's listening to Fox News.
Heard the good news about COVID-19 vaccines? They're here, but you can do more than wait for your turn. Here's how. Stay at least 6 feet away from folks you don't live with. And it's risky to be indoors with them, too. And masks? Well, they protect both the person wearing them and the folks around them. Wear a mask, watch your distance, and make a big difference now.
Learn more about vaccines at cdc.gov/coronavirus. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
So much is happening, but who can you trust? You need to check out Newsmax TV, the fastest growing news channel in America. Watch it on all major cable systems and see shows with Sean Spicer, Greg Kelly, Lindsay Keith, Stinchfield, and Rob Schmidt. They're giving you the real story on Biden and Pelosi. So download the free Newsmax app on your smartphone now or watch Newsmax on Roku, YouTube, Pluto, Zumo, and more. 30 million Americans watch Newsmax TV. So should you.
Republicans don't like it, but the House has advanced that Corona financial aid bill, including more direct payments to Americans and extended and extra unemployment benefits and a whole lot more. Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy doesn't want.
It's what the Democrats always want to do, spend more money from hardworking taxpayers.
The $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan, backed by the White House, cleared the House Budget Committee on a 19-16 vote with no Republican support.
This February, an American has died of COVID every 32 seconds. So while debate is important, we also need to get on with it.
Committee Chairman Democrat John Yarmuth opened the hearing the day the U.S. marked 500,000 coronavirus deaths. Republicans say the spending package is loaded with partisan pork unrelated to the pandemic response. The Democratic-controlled House is expected to vote on the measure this week. On Capitol Hill, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
On Wall Street, Dow futures are up a bit the day after the Dow rose 27 points, but the NASDAQ could take another big hit, its futures dropping again following a more than 300-point plunge. Facebook has made friends again in Australia.
Facebook says it reached a deal with Australia to restore news to its platform after a five-day shutdown. Australia was considering legislation to require Facebook and Google to pay traditional news media for content. The government says it will amend the legislation.
That's Fox's Carmen Roberts. Baseball's Seattle Mariners need a new CEO after Kevin Mather resigned.
This after a 45-minute video of Mather from a Rotary Club speech earlier this month that received widespread backlash. The speech made on February 5th in Bellevue, Washington, in which Mather attacked the inner workings of the organization and poking fun at the English-speaking abilities of foreign players, even noting that he wanted to avoid paying for a translator for M's pitcher Hisashi Iwakuma upon his return to the franchise.
That's Matt Napolitano. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
What is your quality of life? The Owen Insurance Group plans on improving it on our Quality of Life radio show, Tuesday mornings at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU. Hi, I'm Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group, along with Tom Bouvier. We'll help you on the road of life and make it a better one. Don't forget the Quality of Life radio show, Tuesdays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU on TuneIn and Alexa.
Around Town Magazine is in their 43rd year of publishing. On the cover, Florida orthopedic specialists. Our goal is to make treatment a one-stop shop for our patients, providing university orthopedics in a community setting. On the back cover, Hospice of Okeechobee and Chapters Health Hospice, a special kind of caring since 1983. The 43rd Florida Lifestyle voted the best communities to live, including Indianwood Golf and Country Club, Middlewood Golf and Tennis, Doris Clements Interiors, including 55-plus Living, the Palms of St. Lucie West, Medicana, Boulevard, Boynton Beach Nursing and Rehab Centers, and the Sunrise Theater. Safe fun resorts and attractions. Davis House Inn, Courtyard Marriott, New World of Medicine, Conviva Care Center for Seniors, New Dining, Renato's and Josephine's Ristorante, 2J's Gourmet Deli. Around Town Magazine is power-packed with Nice Air over 47 years, Lotus Gunworks, Mid-Florida Credit Union, Flagler Museum. Celebration of life begins with Acock Funeral Homes and so much more.
The professionals at Mark Breckville Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Coming to you live from Seward, Florida, the greatest little town in the world, it's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
Thank you very much, Madam Announcer. You are listening to the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. We are in hour number two right now.
There's something wrong with you. You're certainly not very good.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know what you mean by that.
Listen, this is the way it is.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you feel that way.
Why exactly are you here?
Well, I am here because I am the host of this radio program, okay? That's why I am here. Official time now is 7:08. Mr. Clock, would you certify that, please?
It's now 7:08 a.m.
Mr. Clock said, it is officially 7:08 a.m., and of course, my work wife is always here with me 5 days a week. Good morning, Miss Bonnie.
Good morning to you, and we say good morning, Treasure Coast. Welcome. Welcome to our show.
I'm going to have to get you a wedding band, because you're married to me on the radio.
Yeah.
And I'll wear one, too, just when we're on the air.
Right.
And then we'll just take them off when we leave and put them on while we're here.
5 days a week,
we are here. I'm married to you 5 days a week. Yep. Jesus Christmas.
15 hours of during our week.
Yay.
That's incredible.
Man, Calgon, take me away.
But the hours go by so quickly.
They do. We have fun.
Mornings just do go by fast for some reason. They always have.
Here.
And it doesn't matter what I'm doing. The hours in the morning always go by the quickest out of the day.
Oh, for sure. Or for shizzle, as they say.
I don't know why that is. Why do you think that is, Evan?
That's because you're having a great time.
Yeah.
That's why.
Does that mean that you're a morning person, maybe?
Well, yeah, and plus, you're in front of me, so you're graced with my presence.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
That's why it goes by so quickly.
That's why they're rolling by
so
fast.
And that's why it rolls by, because I'm graced with your presence.
Yeah.
So that's why they should call us Beauty and the Beast.
Now.
Right? Beauty and the Beast. And that should be the name of the new morning show. It's Beauty and the Beast in the morning.
No, more like Beauty and the Beat. Because you're the beat.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
You got the beat. You got the beat of the show.
Well, I don't know. I'm pretty beastly, too. So, I mean,
no.
Why not? What the heck?
No.
The Get Up and Go Show with Beauty and the Beast. There you go. That's the new name of the show. I like that.
Oh, yeah. That's a movie I would see again if they had it on the big screens around here.
Yeah?
I would definitely go capture that one again back at the theater.
All right. I love it.
All right.
Very nice. Let's do birthdays, anniversaries back in the day. All right, Bonnie, of course, you started off every single weekday with birthdays and anniversaries. What do you got for
me? I don't have any birthdays to tell this morning.
Nobody?
No, nobody.
Wow.
No anniversaries that I'm seeing either. Not that I know of, you know. Yeah, nobody.
Well, my birthday's in 22 days.
Yes.
I'll be the big 6-1.
How are you celebrating this year?
Right here with you.
Are you going out to eat or anything?
Nope.
Didn't you do a family dinner?
I was supposed to work at the stadium, but with the baseball schedule revised, we're not going to have a game now on St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, okay.
I am free on March 17th. So if anybody would like to take me out for my birthday on St. Patrick's Day, I welcome all people that would like to celebrate.
I'm sure your family is conjuring up a little bit something right now behind
your back. Nothing on my birthday. It's going to happen after my birthday.
Yeah,
we're going to go to... I can't think of that restaurant down in Palm Beach Gardens that I like. They took me to last year, five months late.
What was that called?
Some Texas Day Brazil.
All right.
Yeah, that's where it's like copious amounts of food for one price.
But one large price?
It's about 44 bucks a head.
Yeah.
Which is not very expensive. But, man, they bring out all sorts of meat and steak on a skewer, and you just take what you want.
Ooh, yeah.
And it's just, like I said, it's copious amounts of food. You will be in a food coma by the time you leave there.
Wow.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Speaking of meats on a skewer, I love going to Pueblo Vieja when people
Pueblo
order
Vieja, yeah.
the they order the sizzling fajitas, mm-hmm. and you can just they're taking out those big hot plates, and you can hear the fajitas sizzling as they're
Man,
taking them
you know,
to the table.
The smell is like wow, the smell is unbelievable. Because you get the onions and what else is in a fajita?
A sizzling steak. I think you get onions, possibly green peppers. You can get red peppers. They might put those little green onions in there. Chiles, anything that would spice it up yeah. and makes it
Let me
it
call my chef in here with a fajita. Hold on.
You made my life complete.
There we go. How's that, huh? Right? There's that sizzle sound. See, I had a fajita ready for you in the other room.
Oh, you know what? It's my birthday next month, too, and I think...
You forgot about
when
that.
When we go to DeLand, I think that's going to be my birthday request is let's... If they have a Pueblo Viejo there...
Okay.
Or if they have, like, a really good Mexican restaurant, mm-hmm. I'm going to request that with the family.
Okay. All right. Just make sure and bring your Rolaids with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Mexican food does not sit right with me all that well. I get a lot of heartburn every now and then. I've slowed down a lot on what I eat now, especially at night, because I have learned a really good hard lesson that if you eat too late at night and you go to bed, you're waking up in the middle of the night with heartburn.
Heartburn.
I was nauseated this morning at like 12:30. I woke up 11:30, yeah. 12:30. I woke up. And I was nauseated for some reason.
That's not any fun.
No.
I have Pepcid AC lately. I have some of that in the cupboard. It's like a dual action thing that I take once in a while.
Yeah. I can't take Pepto-Bismol. It makes me puke.
Oh, with Pepto-Bismol.
Oh, that is so nasty.
It doesn't coat and soothe your stomach it says so
nasty.
On the bottle.
Oh, that is nasty. That's like puke medicine for me.
When I have some of that, it to me it reminds me of just liquidated bubble gum. That's all it is. Yes.
Bazooka in a bottle.
Yeah.
Right?
That's what it
Excuse me,
like.
Could you pass me the bazooka in a bottle, please? That is true when you think about it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's strange because I could eat bazooka bubblegum.
Yes.
But I can't drink Pepto-Bismol.
Oh, and you want to know what licorice reminds me of?
Oh, red or black?
Well, kind of like both, but I'm considering the red.
Okay.
So, like, it reminds me, you know, my mom and dad used to have, like, a red Oldsmobile.
Right.
And the car seats were red vinyl.
Right.
And I never, you know, sunk my teeth into their vinyl red car seat.
Okay.
But to me, that's what red licorice is like eating to me.
See this stuff right here that I brought up?
I don't like licorice.
See this stuff I brought up right here? My parents used to give me this when I was a kid and I'd get nauseated. It's called Emitrol.
Emitrol? I think I've heard of that. What is it?
Emitrol. It's a non-drowsy, rapid nausea relief medicine. That's all that I know.
Did it work for you?
Well, when I had it, it was only like one flavor. It was like mint.
Yeah.
But now they have all these different flavors.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like times have changed from the 60s.
I've got to say, I've never taken it.
Yeah.
My parents never gave me that.
Yeah, Emitrol.
I was young, it was just like bear aspirin. You get the little orange bear aspirins that taste like candy.
Yeah, you know, they say take two aspirin and call me in the morning. That's what they say.
Yeah. But what works for me, the dual action, is with if I get heartburn and a headache, I love to take that Alka-Seltzer where it says it right on the box for headache
fizz.
And heartburn.
Oh, what a relief it is.
And, you know, I'm stressed out because I don't even have any of that in the cupboard right now, Evan.
Really?
I got to go back to Publix and buy some.
My phone started making noise. Sorry about that. Dakota Fanning celebrating a birthday today. Dakota's 27. That's Sarah Howard on The Alienist. Emily Blunt is 38. She's starring with The Rock in Jungle Cruise movie.
Emily Blunt. I think for some reason that's Julia Roberts' niece, I'm pretty sure.
Let me see here. It doesn't say on the sheet.
How old is she today?
38.
Yeah.
Aziz Ansari is 38. That's Devon, Master of None. Josh Gad is 40. That's Olaf, the snowman in Frozen. Kelly McDonald, 45. That's Margaret the Widow Schroeder on Boardwalk Empire.
Oh, who did she play in Boardwalk Empire?
Margaret the Widow Schroeder on Boardwalk Empire.
Oh, I got to go back and look at that. How old is she today?
45.
Yeah, that's a series that we watched quite a while ago. Mm-hmm. It was a good one.
Yep.
Boardwalk Empire.
Yep, Boardwalk Empire. Niecy Nash is celebrating a birthday. She's 51. That's Deputy Renisha Williams on Reno 911.
Reno 911, funny yep. lady. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. She is.
Damon John from Shark Tank. He's 52. He is the founder and CEO of FUBU, the clothing line FUBU.
FUBU. FUBU.
F-U-B-U.
FUBU.
Yep. Right. Mark Price, 53. That's Skippy on Family Ties. Kristen Davis is 56. That's Charlotte on Sex and the City.
She's 56 today.
56 years old today.
And yesterday we had her boyfriend from the show having a birthday, Kyle MacLachlan.
Yep. Yep, for Shizzle. Continuing on with birthdays, Howard Jones, 66 years old today. That's the 80s singer. He had few hits, What Is Love, Life in One Day, Things Can Only Get Better. That's the only thing that I remember
no
from
one
him.
Is to blame.
And no one I is think, to blame.
I think he did that too.
Yeah, that's another good
one. It
was
probably his biggest.
I remember playing that when I used to do part-time on the coast.
Did you?
Yeah, yeah, we used to do Things Can Only Get Better and No One Is to Blame.
What year was that when you were playing that?
Oh God, I don't know, but those are depressing songs.
I think that's even before I came.
Yeah.
Because I don't remember playing that one. I think I played that up in Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Brad Whitford is 69. That's Aerosmith's rhythm guitarist. Patricia Richardson is 70. That's Tim Allen's wife, Jill Taylor, on Home Improvement.
Yeah, Jill from Home Improvement. Yep. She played excellent actress, yep. Excellent as that mom.
The one and only Ed Tuttle Jones, 70 years old today, played for the Dallas Cowboys, 6'9" tall. Celebrating birthdays in the heavens, the one and only Peter Fonda passed away in 2019. That's Jane Fonda's brother and Bridget Fonda's father. Johnny Winter, albino Edgar's heavily tattooed albino brother. Celebrating a birthday in the heavens, he passed away in 2014.
Oh, yeah, the Winter brothers.
Oh, yes.
Yep.
Today is a day that we'll always remember and will always go down. You know why?
Let's see, February 22nd or is it 23rd?
Today's the 23rd. Yes, and I so wish Phil was here right now.
Why is this?
Because it's National Dog Biscuit Day. National Dog Biscuit Day.
Oh, I wonder if
Phil... And I want to dedicate today to the one and only Phil Benfield, who comes in and co-hosts with us every now and then. They call him Phil. He does the top 10. He's got a YouTube show. It's National Dog Biscuit Day, and today's show is dedicated to Phil.
You know, the next time he comes in with those biscuits, too, and eats them, yep. We got to make them a little better and put a little raspberry on the biscuit for
That's
him.
That's a great idea. Bring in a little jar of raspberry jam.
Yeah.
And then he can dip it in there, and he could double dip all he wants because it'll be just for him.
Yeah, we don't want it.
Yes.
That's right, Evan. We don't want it.
For Shizzle, without a doubt. National Dog Biscuit Day. This is dedicated to the one and only Phil Benfield.
I wonder if my kitty would like to chew on a dog biscuit. I doubt
it. You could try. Yeah. I mean, you know, cat's teeth are much more brittle than
they are
dog's teeth.
They're sharp little dangerous teeth.
Right?
Man,
they're like razor blades.
Have you ever been bitten by a cat before?
No, but I've been scratched by a cat before.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And let me tell you, getting scratched by a cat or ticking off a cat is no joke. And especially when they make that noise, that noise.
It can give you a
Man.
Fever. My cat was sneezing this morning. I think he has
really?
COVID or something. He was.
Your cat sneezing?
Jack Frosty was sneezing like 9 times in a row.
Oh, my.
Hansi was looking at him like, you know, and then Hansi was trying to paw him, and then Jack stopped sneezing, and he puts up his paw like, get away.
How does a cat sneeze? Can you make that sound?
Oh, he just a regular sneeze, a little achoo. You know,
does it go
like,
achoo?
Just like we do in
really?
Just little smaller kitty form.
Oh, yep. Okay. So it's a kitty sneeze.
But he did that so many
Never
times.
Never seen a kitty sneeze before.
In a row, yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Very interesting. Here's something else that's interesting right now. It's time for news that interests everybody. 7:20 on the Get Up and Go show. Let's go to the morning news desk with Bonnie. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. The pace of a vaccine distribution is picking up across Florida, but vaccine hesitancy continues to be a problem, especially among minority communities. Dr. Alric Simmons of Advent Health, himself African-American, understands that concern.
Heard a lot of things around the trust of the community, particularly those who are African-American and Latinx, who have longstanding memories of atrocities that have been committed.
But Dr. Simmons says the vaccine is safe and effective, and you're putting your life in danger each day you hesitate to get vaccinated. President Joe Biden is reportedly considering former U.S. Senator Bill Nelson of Florida to lead NASA. The former head of the space agency, Jim Bridenstine, stepped down as Biden took office. The number of new coronavirus cases is down to just over 4,100, but 159 additional resident deaths are reported, taking the statewide toll over 30,000. A Treasure Coast man is proving it's never too late to chase a dream. WPTV's Megan McRoberts has the story.
Thank you for your patience.
In the comfort of his Stewart home, 88-year-old Felix Taborda, with his wife Laura by his side.
So I'm going to ask you to please raise your right hand.
Takes his oath of allegiance to become a United States citizen.
That I will support.
A moment nearly a decade in the making. Felix and Laura flew to the United States in 2013 upon the pleading of their children living in the U.S., fleeing Venezuela during a time of violent political unrest.
We decided to stay here, to live here, and our country is very, very hard to live in the condition the government they have right now.
Seeking safety and a better life. Despite both being well-educated with important jobs, Felix, a college professor with a Ph.D.
The salary is $6 per month.
Felix knows the United States is still a beacon of hope for many immigrants like him, wanting to call their home a place with shared values.
I like democracy. Freedom.
When a social worker with Treasure Coast Hospice learned that even at his late age, Felix still had set his sights on citizenship, she helped write letters, submit medical documents, helping secure Felix an unusual chance to take his citizenship test at home, as he is in hospice care with stage 4 colon cancer.
So help me God.
Yeah.
Help me God.
Okay, congratulations.
To now sharing citizenship with his wife, who took her oath last year.
Okay, awesome.
Giving them comfort they'll spend the rest of their years together with family and no threat of separation.
We're all together.
Megan McRoberts, WPTV, News Channel 5.
Ford Motor Company has issued a safety compliance recall for 79,017 vehicles in the U.S. for windshield adhesion. Ford says the affected vehicles do not comply with federal motor safety vehicle standards. The front windshields are inadequately bonded to the vehicle body structure. Ford says in the event of a crash, the windshield may not adequately stay in place, increasing the risk of injury. The recall affects 79,017 vehicles in the U.S. and federal territories, 6,986 in Canada, and 1,347 in Mexico. This includes the 2021 Ford F-150 vehicles built at Dearborn Truck Plant from October 27, 2020 to February 3, 2021, and the 2021 Ford Super Duty vehicles built at Kentucky Truck Plant from October 13, 2020 to January 23, 2021. Ford says it's not aware of any accidents or injuries related to the condition. Owner notifications will begin the week of April 6. Dealers will remove and reinstall the windshield using standard services procedures. The families of the victims of the 2019 Naval Air Station Pensacola shooting claim the gunman was a Trojan horse sent by Saudi Arabia. That allegation is part of a federal lawsuit filed on behalf of 16 people, including 3 sailors killed in the attack. Lastly, the fried chicken wars that started late in 2019, they're back. Taco Bell is now throwing their hat in the ring. They just introduced a new fried chicken taco. It's a fried chicken breast wrapped in a puffy piece of flatbread with a chipotle sauce. And for now, they're only available in Nashville and Charlotte, but they're going to roll out nationwide later this year. Steelers coach Mike Tomlin was recently diagnosed with COVID-19. Tomlin, age 48, was diagnosed last week. The Steelers could not confirm the head coach's diagnosis, but said members of the coaching staff and personnel were sent home from the facility last week after a couple of positives came up in routine testing. Now our news time, 7:26. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
If you incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24/7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, say habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
. 7:27, the time on the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together. It's all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, we don't see any accidents to report right here on the Treasure Coast. The traffic moving smoothly north and southbound right here on US 1, and major highways looking so far so good this morning. There's your latest look at traffic. 70 degrees in Stuart, and over in Tempe, Arizona, a clear sky where they're at 52. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
Happy Tuesday sunshine. Waking up this morning to temperatures in the mid-60s. Some isolated rainfall for the morning drive, then clearing conditions through this afternoon with highs in the mid-70s. Tonight, cooler weather makes a return, lows in the upper 50s, mostly clear skies and some patchy fog. Tomorrow, highs in the mid-70s, mostly sunny skies, and a 20% chance for late-day showers. Wednesday into the end of the work week, morning lows in the mid-60s, highs in the low 80s, plenty of sunshine and low rain chances.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Just imagine. Imagine finding a doctor who listens. Imagine a doctor who cares, who takes time to understand you and your lifestyle better. Imagine an entire care team dedicated to helping you live your best life. You don't have to imagine. WellMed is redefining aging with our unique approach to care designed by physicians to help you stay as healthy as possible. Learn more about our recognized model of care at discoverwellmed.com.
Unfortunately, in today's litigious society, too many Americans fail to have an effective estate plan and asset protection strategy. I'm attorney TJ Heineman, and I've been counseling families, businesses, and executives for 20 years. I can help you preserve your wealth, safeguard your assets, and protect your family. My law firm specializes in estate planning and administration, asset protection, corporate law, and real estate. For a free copy of my Family Estate Planning Survival Guide or a free consultation in my Palm City office, call me, TJ Heineman, at 888-5667.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
What are you waiting for? Call the Slim Body Laser Spa in Stuart today and start losing inches today. That's right, lose belly fat, your double chin, flabby thighs, upper arm fat. Well, you get the picture. In a short series of laser-assisted weight loss treatments, you can lose inches of unwanted fat. Call 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
weight, feel great, and look fantastic. With a little help from Dr. Fred J. Rezacker of Slim Body Laser Spa, East Ocean Boulevard in Stuart. And they're online. Visit their website, slimbodylaser.com. In a few short treatments, you'll see results. Lose 3, 6, even 9 inches of unwanted belly fat. The wait is over. Call today, 223-5885. That's
223-5885. The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
You are listening to WSTU, Stuart, Jupiter, and Indiantown, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Let's get back to the Get Up and Go Show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
This is not headline news. Jennifer Lawrence may play the Invisible Girl in the new Fantastic Four movie. But if they want to cast someone who really knows what it's like to be invisible, they should go with an actress over 40. James Vanderbeek had to look for wood to keep his Texas home warm. It's the first time since 2003 he's done something that generated heat. NCIS New Orleans will end after this season. And if you just asked, is that still on? That's why. And Michael Bolton will host a reboot of The Dating Game. You can watch it on ABC. You won't, but you can. This is not headline news.
Well, it's not headline news. It's 7:31, and we go from not headline news to stupid news.
And now it's time for Stupid News.
It's so stupid and awesome.
Where we ask the important questions.
Are some people too stupid to live?
Why are people so stupid?
Are you effing stupid?
Well, we're going to go halfway around the world to Russia. All right, Bonnie, Russia.
Okay.
It's hard to believe, but in Russia, 23-year-old Christina Ozturk has become a mother of 11 babies in just 10 months.
Oh, really? In 10 months. Well,
think about that.
That's the amount of time you do it, right? Is it 9 months and maybe your birth went a little longer and now it's 10? But if she had 11, she beats our Octomom mom right here.
She became the mother of 11 babies in just 10 months. Think about that for a minute. Let that set in. Now, she's only given birth to one baby. Okay, a daughter named Vika. She has had when she was 17. But after Christina married her 56-year-old millionaire husband, she turned to surrogate mothers to have as many babies as possible, as quickly as possible. That turned into 10 babies in just 10 months. Christina and her husband say they don't know how many children they'll end up with having together, but they definitely don't plan on stopping at 10.
Okay, now I can understand she married a multimillionaire, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, she can have all of these children. They definitely can afford it.
Mm-hmm.
But why the choice to...
She wants them all at one time.
Surrogate.
She wants them all at one time. She doesn't want to wait 9 months every time. So she wants them all in one shot. Now, the husband, a transport and property magnate, originally from Turkey, said that Christina was the kind of wife he's always wanted, a diamond in the rough with a pure, kind heart. Despite being twice her age and having adult children of his own, he agreed to start the large family with Christina. So that's why they're doing that.
Well, that's, you know, that's nice that they can.
Yeah.
But they have so much wealth. Why doesn't she maybe like look into adopting little babies? You know, little babies that need a family.
Don't know, because I guess they want to use his sperm in somebody else to make the child, and they want to have 10 kids at once. So that's what they're doing over in Russia.
At once.
Yeah, that's why the population is probably booming over there.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. They definitely have a lot of territory for that population.
Yeah. A lot of insemination going on, that's for sure. A guy named Trevor Scott is a massage therapist. Or no, I'm going to read this in the way it's written. Because, see, I've learned not to use the word masseuse and masseur,
you know,
because of you. I say massage therapist, but I'm going to read this the way it's written, if that's okay with you, Bonnie. Please don't take offense to this. A guy named Trevor Scott is a masseur in Prince George, British Columbia, Canada. And back in the spring of 2019, two female clients filed complaints against him when it seemed like he was touching himself in the most inappropriate of ways while he used his other hand for the massage. Now, after an investigation, the good news is that's not what was really going on. The bad news is he was actually playing games on his cell phone during the massage.
You're not supposed to do that at all, either.
That's not as bad as what he was accused of, but it's still something a massage therapist really isn't supposed to do. So, he just got a 10-day suspension, $3,500 in fines, and a ban from bringing his phone into the massage room.
He only got a suspension?
Yeah.
Well, he's lucky then. He's fortunate because I know of some people that have been fired for having a cell phone in the room during the service. Where I'm at, that's simply not allowed. It's what's called a no rule. It's a it's a strict policy where there's no exceptions. You just you just don't have a cell phone along with you in the room when you're performing the service.
Yeah, definitely so.
So he got what was his fine that you mentioned?
$3,500.
That's pretty steep, but at least he was able to keep his license, and now he wasn't fired from his position.
No, he wasn't fired from his position at all.
Yep.
He was not fired from his position at all. But that's what happened. So note to self, don't bring your damn cell phone in the room with you when you're doing a massage to somebody and reach down and try to play games on it or something because they're going to think you're doing something obscene, they accused him of.
There are places that have strict policies on that one.
Yep. Let's go to Thailand, where there's a guy in Bangkok, Thailand, who was really excited about his date with his girlfriend, and he was planning to bring the thunder in bed. Okay.
Bring the thunder.
Bring the thunder in bed.
Was lightning invited too?
I don't know. So what he did was he grabbed a steel nut out of his toolbox, and he slipped it over his junk.
What in the world?
A big nut about this big, okay, and he slipped it right over his junk. Now, he said he heard that rings like this could make things bigger and stronger down there.
Oh, my word.
But, unfortunately, the nut that he slid over his junk got stuck.
Wow.
And by the next afternoon, when things down there were painful and swollen, he was rushed to the hospital emergency room.
He was hoping his better half was a tool girl, and maybe she had a wrench available.
The doctors were able to cut the nut with a power tool, and they had some serious skills when they did it because they got the nut off without even nicking the guy's junk.
Oh, wow, they were good.
And they say he'll make a full recovery within a few weeks, but sadly, he didn't get to go on his date with the girl.
Oh.
Gentlemen, if you're listening out there and you're looking to, how do we say this, Bonnie, nicely? If you're looking to
wear some jewelry,
yeah. Oh my God! If you're looking to size up,
yeah.
If you're looking to get sized up
with some man jewelry,
don't use a steel nut. Okay, use other forms. There's other medical things that you can do out there.
Yeah. This sounds like one of those stories. There's a show out there called Sex Sent Me to the ER. And look for that one, Evan. You and Rachel would get a kick out of that one.
I've actually seen that show.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that show.
There are some things in that show where you're going, oh, my word.
Oh, yeah.
Lordy.
Things get stuck in the strangest places, and they don't come out. And they go to the ER. Yeah.
Yeah.
But that one, that's pretty interesting.
This one here, right here.
The nut got stuck. That's all I'm going to say. Let's go to Seattle, where it had its snowiest day in 50 years recently. Around 9 inches fell on the ground. And meanwhile, there's these two idiots who decided to break into a house in Tacoma, about 30 miles south of Seattle. And they were still there when the police showed up. They tried to run, but instead of chasing them, the cops just took their time and followed their footprints in the snow.
They followed the tracks.
Yep.
Yep.
They tracked one guy to a church parking lot and found him hiding in a dumpster praying.
Oh, my.
Go figure. And the other guy was just simply hiding in a tree. They're both facing charges for second-degree burglary, and the guy in the dumpster also, he had drugs on him, too.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah.
I don't think any amount of prayer would have helped that guy.
No.
No. There's a Indian man who came to the rescue of a thirsty and potentially deadly cobra by pouring water from a bottle into the venomous snake's mouth.
So the cobra was thirsty?
There was a thirsty cobra.
How did he know that this cobra
I don't know.
I don't know.
But I don't know. But it was an Indian guy who poured water into a cobra's mouth.
Oh, he has some kind of powers.
There's
he
a video
knew.
That's okay. Shared by the Indian Forest Service officer who shows the man, believed to be an IFS official, gently holding the water bottle while the cobra actually drinks from the opening of the bottle.
The cobra is drinking there just like
yes.
you would pour liquid maybe
yes.
down a little squirrel or
yes.
feed a little squirrel.
Yes, the man touches the cobra with his other hand to keep the snake steady and calm while the snake is drinking the water.
He does have magic powers.
Now, I watched the video of this, and I was astounded when I saw this happening.
Yeah.
I was like, wow.
It's like you're wondering if there's other footage, like did he hypnotize the snake first with something?
Yeah.
You know, like maybe play a little flute or something to get the snake in front of him hypnotized.
I don't know, but it was pretty...
That's intense. Yeah.
It was intense to watch this guy feed a cobra from a bottle of water, just a regular Zephyr Hills bottle of water.
That's a very brave thing to do, yes.
Brave? That's an understatement. That is pure insanity. Why would you do something like that? Bonnie, there's not enough money in the world that could pay me to do something like that.
Well, maybe he had been around these dangerous snakes before and knew how to tame them and kind of calm their nerves.
Tame them? That's an understatement.
But of course,
oh my gosh.
Watching the video, it doesn't really calm your nerves at all. Just watching this
no.
guy.
The snake just like drank the water out of the bottle.
Yeah.
Like it was nothing.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of that island called Snake Island, Evan?
No.
There's an island over in Brazil.
Okay.
And it's called Snake Island.
All right.
And it is just loaded with tons of venomous snakes.
That's crazy.
Yeah. I saw a lady from 60 Minutes go there. They went there on a film crew. And apparently, like, if you're a regular civilian, you mm-hmm. can't even go there. It's off limits. It's like only if you're like a nationalist or you take care of the island or some sort of thing can you go. But they had the crew from 60 Minutes go there, and they kind of like went up into these little mountains, like this little mountain forest area. And just within like maybe 8 minutes they were in there, they already started to see snakes. And you could see the lady from 60 Minutes really getting a little nervous and a little feverish. And but yeah, it's called Snake Island. It's in Brazil, and it's just
wow.
loaded with these poisonous
You wouldn't
snakes.
Catch you wouldn't catch me on that damn island. That's
no.
for sure.
No.
Oh heck no.
Me neither.
Yeah, I'm agreeing with you. It is 7:44 news time. All brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry. Make sure and stop by and see my good friend Hawk Levy at St. Lucie Jewelry for the best deals in town. It's St. Lucie Jewelry. Let's go to the news desk. Here's Bonnie.
Thanks, Evan. A top state official and the mayor of one of Florida's largest cities say they will disregard Governor Ron DeSantis' order to lower flags to half staff in honor of the late talk show host Rush Limbaugh.
State Agriculture Commissioner Nikki Fried says lowering the flag to half-staff is a sacred honor that pays respect to those she calls fallen heroes and patriots. As a result, she's ordering all state offices under her direction to ignore the governor's order, saying the state will not celebrate hate speech, bigotry, and division. Meanwhile, St. Pete Mayor Rick Kreisman says he won't lower the flag for Limbaugh either, saying the city won't honor racism, homophobia, or anything else he's spewed over the years. Kreisman says the city will, however, honor the life of Pinellas County Sheriff's Deputy Michael Magley, who was killed in the line of duty last week. I'm Reed Shepard.
The number of new coronavirus cases is down to just over 4,100, but 159 additional resident deaths are reported, taking the statewide toll over 30,000. A Treasure Coast man is proving it's never too late to chase a dream. WPTV's Megan McRoberts has that story.
Thank you for your patience.
In the comfort of his Stewart home, 88-year-old Felix Taborda, with his wife Laura by his side.
So I'm going to ask you to please raise your right hand.
Takes his oath of allegiance to become a United States citizen.
That I will support.
A moment nearly a decade in the making. Felix and Laura flew to the United States in 2013 upon the pleading of their children living in the U.S., fleeing Venezuela during a time of violent political unrest.
We decided to stay here, to live here, and our country is very, very hard to live in the condition the government they have right now.
Seeking safety and a better life. Despite both being well-educated with important jobs, Felix, a college professor with a PhD.
The salary is $6 per month.
Felix knows the United States is still a beacon of hope for many immigrants like him, wanting to call their home a place with shared values.
I like democracy. Freedom.
When a social worker with Treasure Coast Hospice learned that even at his late age, Felix still had set his sights on citizenship, she helped write letters, submit medical documents, helping secure Felix an unusual chance to take his citizenship test at home, as he is in hospice care with stage 4 colon cancer.
So help me God.
Yeah. Help me God.
Okay, congratulations.
To now share in citizenship with his wife, who took her oath last year.
Okay, awesome.
Giving them comfort they'll spend the rest of their years together with family and no threat of separation.
We're all together.
Megan McRoberts, WPTV, News Channel 5.
Gas prices in Florida are up 15 cents this week compared to last, the highest they've been in over a year.
There's a good chance that we could even see another hike this week of a few cents, maybe even up to 5 cents. It's hard to say.
AAA's Mark Jenkins, that's because of refinery outages in Texas caused by the winter freeze. The main mansion that actor John Travolta shared with his late wife, actor Kelly Preston, has been put up for sale. The 67-year-old star of Grease and Saturday Night Fever recently listed the home on Islesboro, an island off the coast of Maine, for $5 million, according to the Portland Press-Herald. The couple bought the home in 1991 as newlyweds and turned it from a very dark and somber house into a bright family home for their soon-to-be-born son, Jet, according to a 1999 feature in Architectural Digest. And lastly, SpaceX is planning to launch the first all-civilian flight this fall, and a 29-year-old woman who beat cancer as a kid just got a free ticket. Her name is Haley Arsenault. She was a patient at St. Jude's 2 decades ago and now works there as a physician assistant. A billionaire named Jared Isaacman is paying for her seat, and you could also win one by donating at least $10 to St. Jude's by this Sunday. Evidently, no amount of money will get quarterback Carson Wentz his number 11 jersey with his new team, the Indianapolis Colts. Colts second-year receiver Michael Pittman Jr., who currently wears number 11, says he has talked to Wentz about the number, and the answer is no on a possible switch. I am number 11, Pittman told TMZ Sports. I don't think there's any deal that is going to be done. It's not uncommon for players on new teams to try to buy their preferred jersey number for a large amount of money from one of their teammates. News time now is 7:49. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
first time I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored, and then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
7:50, the time right now on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Waterway Dermatology. Dr. Ryan Shearing is located at 1050 Monterey Road in Stewart, bringing personalized health care back to dermatology the Waterway. Bonnie?
We have a nice ride here throughout Port St. Lucie, and also in Stewart, we're looking at a good ride coming across the Roosevelt Bridge. Everything looks well, nothing tied up. No accidents to report through the entire Treasure Coast. There's your latest look at traffic. And it's 69 in Port St. Lucie, and where our friend George is listening this morning in good old Kentucky, it's 60. Here's our weather at WPTV.
Happy Tuesday sunshine. Waking up this morning to temperatures in the mid-60s. Some isolated rainfall for the morning drive, then clearing conditions through this afternoon with highs in the mid-70s. Tonight, cooler weather makes a return, lows in the upper 50s, mostly clear skies and some patchy fog. Tomorrow, highs in the mid-70s, mostly sunny skies and a 20% chance for late-day showers. Wednesday into the end of the work week, morning lows in the mid-60s, highs in the low 80s, plenty of sunshine and low rain chances. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Dermatology is now open in Stewart, a new independently owned dermatology practice with Dr. Ryan Shearing, board certified for your medical or cosmetic skincare needs. Office hours 9 to 5 Monday through Saturday with extended hours from 9 to 7 on Thursdays. Serving Martin and St. Lucie counties in the Monterey Triangle Building, US 1 and Monterey Road, Stewart. Waterway Dermatology, bringing personalized health care back to dermatology the Waterway. Book a consultation at waterwayderm.com or call 561-926-6150 for Waterway Dermatology. At TMI and Associates, they've been helping individuals and business owners for over 36 years. If you own a business, find out how you can increase your cash flow by over $100,000 with just a 15-minute evaluation. And individuals, get a no-cost analysis of your last 2 years of returns to see if you can save even more. So whether it's payroll, bookkeeping, or individual needs, TMI has you covered. So give them a call, 772-971-5852.
No hype, just facts. I'm Casey, and I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show at my new time, Wednesdays at 10 a.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It is a fun and interesting hour beginning at 10 a.m. every Wednesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at the Casey Ingram Show.
Hi, I'm Chris Hodgins with My Florida Insurance Broker, and I'm here today with my daughter, Sage.
Hello.
Sage, why don't you tell everybody what kind of insurance we do?
Home insurance, car insurance, life insurance, and flood insurance.
If you've had a rate hike or two or five, hopefully not 10, give us a call. We'd love to hear from you. Sage, what's our number?
772-617-6777.
What's the name of our company again?
My Florida Insurance Broker.
Today in Ag News, I'm a Southeast Ag Network. The U.S. Supreme Court on Monday plunged back into the years-long water battle between Florida and Georgia, and at times sounded skeptical of arguments that more water should be directed to Florida in a river system shared by the two states. According to the News Service of Florida, the fight is rooted in that collapse of the iconic oyster industry in Apalachicola Bay in the southern end of the Apalachicola-Chattahoochee-Flint River system. Of course, it starts in northern part of Georgia. Florida continues to contend that Georgia farmers use too much water to irrigate crops, thus causing downstream damage to the Apalachicola River and that Franklin County Bay. But during an hour-long hearing Monday, justices pointed to conflicting evidence about whether Georgia's water use is responsible for damage in the bay. Georgia has argued that the oyster industry sustained damage because of over-harvesting during the 2010 Deepwater Horizon disaster. More of this story can be found on our website, southeastagnet.com.
Winter break is coming to an end for cattle parasites, so start your parasite fight now. With Safeguard feed formulations, keeping up that fight is easier than ever. Available in blocks, cubes, pellets, or free choice mineral, Safeguard feed formulations are the convenient, labor-saving way to deworm cattle on grass. Simply add it to your current feed and mineral program. No processing, no shoot, no added stress. Remember to consult your veterinarian for assistance in the diagnosis, treatment, and control of parasitism. Smart shoppers will tell you they found it on HiBid.com. HiBid.com lets you explore thousands of auctions across the U.S. and around the world. You'll find gold coins, sporting goods, classic cars, collectible toys, fine jewelry, household items, and sports memorabilia autographed by the greats. HiBid.com has hundreds of thousands of items for sale every day. It's easy to search, and it's easy to find auctions in your area. Just go to HiBid.com. That's HIBID.com. And see what everyone is talking about.
Randall Wiseman, Southeast AgNet.
Do you have a suggestion for the show? Send us an email, WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. And now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
Kellogg's and a drug cartel from South America bring you the newest breakfast cereal. It's cocaine-coated cornflakes. Nothing gets you going in the morning like a big bowl of white powder-coated cornflakes. Sure, they're loaded with sugar, but they're also sprinkled with nose candy, snow, dust, flakes, speedball, cocaine-coated cornflakes.
They're great! Now, say hello to my little friend.
Get yours today from Customs and Border Protection as part of this complete drug bust.
Now, have you ever looked at cornflakes when you eat them, Bonnie, and you do notice that they do have that white coating on them?
Yeah, they have like that white, fresh little look of powder.
Yeah, going to make you think twice about that next time you eat cornflakes.
It will.
Right?
And, you know, I guess I can only make that. I wish that the sugar coating will make me feel as good as the cocaine might.
Yes, Tony. Might. Wait. As Tony the Tiger would say, they're great.
Wonder if that's why Tony the Tiger, he's so hyper.
Man,
right?
I don't know. I honestly don't know. That's one tiger I don't want to meet.
Like, remember the days when they said when Coca-Cola was made at first, there mm-hmm. was really a little bit of cocaine ingredient
yeah.
hidden in the true product of Coca-Cola yeah. at
you
one
You know, that's
time.
Something my parents used to give me, too, when I was... when I was a child, when I felt nauseated, they would give me like a tablespoon of just straight Coke syrup.
Oh, did they?
And for some reason, it soothed my stomach.
Was there any like extra medicine in it? Or
no.
Was it just kind of like a Coke syrup that was involved?
Just Coke syrup.
My parents never gave me that. They would always give me like a glass of ginger ale or 7-Up that would kind of soothe my stomach.
7-Up is another, that and ginger ale. Yeah, like you said, ginger ale is another good home antidote, another good remedy.
Yes.
To take.
In fact, I was wishing I had some last evening when I thought I could be coming down with a cold or something.
Mm-hmm. Well, you and seem fine today.
Yeah. No, it was all due to the pollen and the pollen count yesterday.
Oh, so it's the pollen. You blame it on the pollen like Millie Vanilli blamed it on the rain.
I do. I mean, it was making me feel really sick
yesterday.
Maybe
I should do a parody song, Blame It on the Pollen. What do you think? You think that would go over good?
Yeah, because the pollen lately is every right? little bit to blame. I hate it when it gets so thick on my car, Evan, and my vehicle that I can write my name in that yellow pollen.
Well, just put my name on your car, too, while you're at it, okay? Then Gary will start wondering about us.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're going to take a step back. Major John Budensiek is going to be here from the Martin County Sheriff's Office a little bit after 8 o'clock in the morning and talking all things Martin County. So we'll step back. Bonnie and I are going to let the band play on right here at WSTU Stewart, Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next, and then we'll be back with hour number three for you and me right here on Martin County's Heritage Station.
Counting. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News.
We have to resist viewing East life as a statistic or a blur or on the news.
President Biden held a moment of silence and candles were lit at the White House to remember the 500,000 COVID victims in the U.S. while the president urged us to stay vigilant.
Stay socially distanced, to mask up, get vaccinated when it's your turn.
The number of new coronavirus cases remains much lower, only topping 100,000 twice in the past 2 weeks, 56,000 reported yesterday. House Democrats advanced the president's $1.9 billion COVID financial aid bill out of committee with no Republican support, Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy.
This is supposed to be a COVID bill. Only 9% of it goes to COVID.
It does include more direct payments to Americans and extra and enhanced unemployment benefits. In 2 hours...
Hearings start today into who knew what when about the Capitol Hill riot last month. The Senate Homeland Security Committee will be hearing from former Capitol Police Chief Stephen Sund, the former sergeants-at-arms for both the House and Senate, as well as former D.C. Acting Police Chief Robert Confey.
That's Fox's Jill Nato. He stirred up controversy in life, and now 6 days after conservative talk radio icon Rush Limbaugh died, there is controversy over his remembrance in Florida, where Fox's Evan Brown is live.
Yeah, Dave, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis is ordering all state offices to lower their flags to half-staff, honoring late conservative Rush Limbaugh for being a legend. But Florida's Commissioner of Agriculture and Consumer Services is telling all agencies and offices in her department to ignore that order. Commissioner Nikki Fried, the lone Democrat to hold statewide office in Florida and thought to be a challenger to DeSantis' re-election, calls the order political, Dave.
America's listening to Fox News.
Heard the good news about COVID-19 vaccines? They're here, but you can do more than wait for your turn. Here's how. Stay at least 6 feet away from folks you don't live with. And it's risky to be indoors with them, too. And masks? Well, they protect both the person wearing them and the folks around them. Wear a mask, watch your distance, and make a big difference now.
Learn more about vaccines at cdc.gov/coronavirus. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
So much is happening, but who can you trust? You need to check out Newsmax TV, the fastest-growing news channel in America. Watch it on all major cable systems and see shows with Sean Spicer, Greg Kelly, Lindsey Keith, Stinchfield, and Rob Schmidt. They're giving you the real story on Biden and Pelosi. So download the free Newsmax app on your smartphone now or watch Newsmax on Roku, YouTube, Pluto, Zumo, and more. 30 million Americans watch Newsmax TV. So should you.
Two more of President Biden's cabinet picks have hearings at the Senate Health and Human Services Secretary. Some Republicans oppose Javier Becerra, calling him an extremist with a liberal agenda. Also the nominee for Interior Secretary, Deb Haaland, says that oil and natural gas will continue to play a major role in America, but we need to address climate change and recognize that the energy industry is changing. It is also day two for Attorney General Merrick Garland's hearing.
I'm not the president's lawyer.
Judge Merrick Garland says he won't bow to pressure in any direction if confirmed as Attorney General.
I would not have taken this job if I thought that politics would have any influence over prosecutions and investigations.
In questioning from Republican senators, Garland also said he does not see any reason to think Special Counsel John Durham will not finish his look at the origins of the Russia probe. A full Senate vote on Garland's nomination could come as soon as next week. On Capitol Hill, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
More than a year after a deadly attack at a Florida military base, Saudi Arabia is being sued.
Mohammed Saeed al-Shamrani fatally shot 3 U.S. sailors and injured 13 other people at Naval Air Station Pensacola in late 2019. But his victims and their families say the Saudi Air Force officer wasn't a lone wolf. They claim in a lawsuit that the Saudi government knew al-Shamrani had been radicalized and that other Saudi cadets training at the base knew the shooting was coming but did nothing to stop it. U.S. officials last year revealing al-Shamrani communicated with al-Qaeda operatives about plans and tactics weeks before the attack. A month after the shooting, Attorney General William Barr announced 21 Saudi trainees would be sent home. President Trump told reporters the kingdom would help the families very greatly, but the plaintiffs say the Saudis never compensated them. Steve Rappaport, Fox News.
On Wall Street, Dow futures are up a little bit. NASDAQ futures are down big. I'm Dave Anthony, and this is Fox News.
Hello, this is Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. We are a local independent insurance agency located right here on the Treasure Coast. I've been a resident here for 34 years and have helped thousands of clients with their insurance planning needs. We specialize in life, health, and Medicare insurance planning. Don't travel the road alone. Let us be your guide. We are the Owen Insurance Group. Contact us today at 772-210-1020 or visit our website at oweninsurancegroup.net.
Around Town Magazine is in their 43rd year of publishing. On the cover, Florida orthopedic specialists. Our goal is to make treatment a one-stop shop for our patients, providing university orthopedics in a community setting. On the back cover, Hospice of Okeechobee and Chapters Health Hospice, a special kind of caring since 1983. The 43rd Florida Lifestyle voted the best communities to live, including Indianwood Golf and Country Club, Meadowwood Golf and Tennis, Doris Clements Interiors, including 55-plus Living, the Palms of St. Lucie West, Medicana, Boulevard, Boynton Beach Nursing and Rehab Centers, and the Sunrise Theater. Safe, fun resorts and attractions. Davis House Inn, Courtyard Marriott, New World of Medicine, Conviva Care Center for Seniors, New Dining, Renato's and Josephine's Ristorante, 2J's Gourmet Deli. Around Town Magazine is power-packed with Nice Air over 47 years, Lotus Gunworks, Mid-Florida Credit Union, Flagler Museum. Celebration of life begins with Acock Funeral Homes and so much more.
The professionals at Mark Breckville Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
You know what that means when you hear this sound, Bonnie.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's time to hear
it's
from the sheriff's
it's not
office.
The sheriff. It's not the sheriff, but it's the sheriff's office.
Yes.
I would never play this for Sheriff Snyder. He'd shoot me through the phone.
He might get a kick out of it. I don't know.
I don't know. He might. Maybe. I might have to try it. But, you know, but this is Major Budensiek's music. So I can't take it away from Major Budensiek.
There you have it.
You know, because then he'd be probably jelly. You know, you get jealous. Anyway, we'd like to welcome in Major John Budensiek from the Martin County Sheriff's Office. John, how are you today?
I'm good, y'all. I'm trying to remember when that became my music.
You know,
did I pick that?
No, I did.
Oh, okay.
I picked it for you. Just I thought it was apropos.
Fair enough.
That's a big boy word, apropos.
Yeah, and don't worry, Major Budensiek. I can't really remember when that music started for you either, but aren't you glad it did?
I'm not sure about that.
We're just all giddy this morning. I'm sorry.
Got up too early.
I know.
It was that sugary stuff in his cornflakes.
It was the cornflakes we talked about last hour in Stupid News that were – we have a commercial we played that talked about cornflakes that are now laced with cocaine. But it was a bit. It wasn't real, so don't worry.
It's never real.
Yeah, it's not real, so don't worry. Anyway, there's a serious issue going on right now with immigrants. And I wanted to have a conversation about that with you guys. And let's talk a little bit about a big rescue that happened over the weekend, if we could.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, Martin County, for that matter, the whole east coast of Florida on the south end has been a target for illegal immigrant landings forever. I mean, it's been going on for years and years, but there was a pretty good lull, and I'm not trying to connect with the politics, but there probably is a political connection. There's a pretty good lull towards the end of the Trump administration's hold, and now it's just seems to be wide open, people trying to come across and land here in the United States. Unfortunately, they don't always make it. They leave whatever country or wherever they are. Sometimes they don't really have a plan to get here or how they're going to get here. I think they can just hop in the ocean and they're going to drift and land here, and we all know that it doesn't work that way.
Yeah, I'm actually looking at that video as you're speaking on your Facebook page. Very dramatic video.
It is, and thankfully, that boat actually caps, I call it a boat, that basically was a bunch of styrofoam lashed together with a visqueen sail attached to it.
Right.
We live in Martin County, and we have some of the best seamen, fishermen probably in the world, and they would all tell you, you can go out on a rough day in a sport fishing boat and still be in trouble and not make it. Of course, every once in a while we lose a fisherman or somebody that was experienced and knew what they're doing. Now, fast forward to what you're looking at on that video.
Mm-hmm.
Eight people, two of which were pregnant, lash styrofoam together, leave Cuba, and somehow end up on our shores here in Martin County. Thankfully, they ended up here.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
If you recall a couple weeks ago,
yeah,
there were 16 people missing out of Fort Pierce that never were located. So I think that happens probably more than we know.
Yeah, they had to, we had that news story last week, Major, and it looks like they searched, and then we had the story on the following morning where they stopped the search, because there's just no more. But they did, every possible thing that they could, I guess.
That video is very compelling, and it's at the same time, it's very disturbing to watch how they're all crammed in that makeshift vessel. And then a wave just overtook the vessel from behind. They never saw the wave coming, and it just capsized the vessel.
Yeah, and that's a perfect storm. So those people had been afloat for 16 days. The last 2 days, they had no food and water. So they're wore out to start with. It's not like you and I go swimming and can tread water for the next 2 or 3 hours.
Right.
They're at the bottom line, physically, emotionally, mentally, and that boat capsizes. It's by the grace of God that they were close to the shore. Because if not, they're in no position to swim and try to protect their own lives.
We're watching the video, and it's like that really is made of styrofoam. You can see the white, and then you wonder what did they put slabs of wood in between it and kind of like super glue slab it together or something. That's just amazing.
It points towards, and I am sympathetic towards people that are wanting to find a better life and come over here. I don't agree with them coming here in the fashion that they do, and I don't agree. I'm not trying to get political. I don't agree with how things have always gone in our system when it comes to immigration at all. However, it does show the desperation that they have to get over to our country. I know we have our infighting and we have our issues, but whatever we have going on is a whole lot better than what they have going on, and that shows you how desperate they are.
Now, what was that clear piece of plastic on the front? Was that like a makeshift-type sail that they raised and lowered, or what was that?
That was an attempt at a makeshift sail. It was basically visqueen that they were trying to use to sail that vessel.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So,
mm-hmm. You know, and that's you're looking at something that we actually found. Lord only knows how many of those, you know, strike out from the Bahamas or mm-hmm. from Cuba or wherever they come from and don't make it. They just get lost at sea, and the sea swallows them up. I'm sure there's a lot of them because their family's not looking for them anymore, and nobody over here is expecting them to arrive here. So, you know, the ocean turns into a black hole.
You would think that a lot of them, you would think that most of them would try to come maybe like to Key West, since isn't like Key West and Cuba only 100 miles across the waters apart, if I'm not mistaken?
They are, and they do. On regular boats, you know, it happens a lot down there. But when you hop on a styrofoam raft, you kind of go wherever the...
Yeah, you go where the current takes you.
Where it's going to take you.
Yeah, I mean, you could wind up in Jacksonville for all you know.
All right, so it's not like you're going to be navigating that.
No, they don't have no navigation on those things, that's for sure.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, they're just, it's just push it in the water. They leave in the darkness of night when nobody is awake, and away they go, and they just hope to land in a better country, in a better place than what they're leaving from.
Yeah.
With nothing
but... clearly no... checking the weather, checking the sea state, you know, back to our fishermen here in Stewart, those guys, they've got it dialed in. They know when to go to the Bahamas. They check it. You know, the ocean's been rough for the last couple of weeks. So they probably got in the ocean when it was rough, and they've been taking a beating for 16 days at sea.
Do we have a status on the immigrants if everybody's okay?
They're stable. You know, we get those a lot, unfortunately, where they're dehydrated and they're just beat down. But they take them to the hospital. They give them IVs. They feed them. You know, they're going to be okay. They're not drowned or, you know, they're not mm-hmm. drowning victims. So mm-hmm. they're going to be okay. It was a matter of some hypothermia and being undernourished.
Right. Now, what happens? What is the protocol? Because a lot of our listeners have no idea what happens once they're nursed back to, you know, being healthy. They go to the hospital, and of course our taxpaying dollars has to pay for all of that, because they obviously have no money. And then what happens once they're released from the hospital? Do they get arrested by your department? What's the next things that goes on for them?
So our department only rounds them up. We're not federal officers, so we don't have a statute to enforce border crossings. So the federal government does, unfortunately, and I'm not trying to poke too many holes in that, but that's not a real strong system that they have set up. So we put a lot of time and effort into rounding these individuals up, mm-hmm. and it needs to be done. We can't have them running them around on Hutchinson Island and Jupiter Island. But a lot of times they go down to West Palm Beach, they're fingerprinted, and then they're released with a court date. And
wow.
How many times do you think they show back up to go to court?
So they basically, so they're released, so they're not extradited back to their originating country where they came from?
No. Sometimes they are, but in a scenario like that where they've made it to land and they've made it to the hospital, they're given a court date and they're released. Now, if we catch them out at sea, they'll transfer them from our boat to a Coast Guard cutter, take them straight back out, and reunite them with whatever country, repatriate them with whatever country they came from.
Oh,
but
my.
Once they make it to land, things get real, real complicated. And it goes, you know, the country that they're coming from, if they're coming from Cuba, which is a communist country,
mm-hmm.
then throughout the years, you know, the wet foot, dry foot law, I know that's changed throughout the last couple of years, but if they make it to land, for the most part, because they're coming from a communist country, they get to stay here. China also applies in that scenario, and we do get Chinese. Russia applies if the people say the right thing, and we do get Russians. So it really all depends on the the country that their country of origin and what the circumstances are.
Wow, that's amazing that that happens.
It's so, a complicated process, but, you know, I know illegal immigration is a huge point of contention, but that video shows, you know, what goes on out there in that ocean probably on a weekly basis, not a daily basis, but probably on a weekly basis. And I think it's important, you know, that people know what's going on out there.
Wow, that's amazing.
It certainly is.
Very compelling video. I watched it, and Bonnie watched it, and our facial expressions were like, wow, that's what they have to endure for the amount of time they're out there with no food, no water, the sun beating down on them, the different changes of the weather. And then you said there was a couple of ladies that were pregnant too, right?
Yeah, that's a whole other conversation. I know under the Trump administration, he was trying to cut down on that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, females that are pregnant coming into the country to intentionally have a baby, and then, of course, you know, their child is a United States citizen.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I personally think we get played as the nice United States. People know our laws, and they know how we function.
Mm-hmm.
And so they come our way and take advantage of the system. I know, you know, that's a kind of a controversial subject, but that's my opinion.
Wow, wow. Amazing. Good stuff there.
Yeah.
It's Major John Budensiek from the Martin County Sheriff's Office. Martin County Sheriff's Office always on this program each and every Tuesday at this time to give us an update and talk about things that are happening in the news and catch us up to date. John, always a pleasure, and hopefully I will see you here in studio before the end of the year.
I
just had to take the jab. I'm sorry, you know.
Well, we'll see.
All right, we'll see. All right. And you don't even have to bring us donuts. You could just bring a smiling face. That's all we care about.
I heard you're on a diet, so we're off the donuts.
I am on a diet. I'm doing good, actually. I'm maintaining, which is good.
Very good.
Which is good. All right, John, we'll talk to you soon. Have a great day. All right, talk to you soon. 8:21 right now. It's news time, and let's head over to the news desk where the headlines are standing by with Bonnie. But before we do that, we have to give you the precious metals report, and it's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. Gold opening up at $1,810.50 an ounce, and silver opening up at $27.85 an ounce. When we return, Bonnie will have the headlines.
Into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
Hey, 22 news time. Let's go to the news desk, and here's Bonnie.
Thanks, Evan. As the U.S. surpassed 500,000 coronavirus-related deaths on Monday, President Joe Biden directed that the U.S. flag be flown at half-staff through sundown on Friday. The rate of coronavirus deaths has increased in recent months. Half of the 500,000 deaths have occurred in the last 3 months. From the White House, Biden addressed the nation on Monday. Biden then joined his wife, Jill Biden, along with Vice President Kamala Harris and her husband, Doug Emhoff, for a moment of silence outside the White House. Earlier on Monday, the National Cathedral rang 500 church bells, one for every 1,000 Americans who died from the coronavirus since early last year. The pace of vaccine distribution is picking up across Florida, but vaccine hesitancy continues to be a problem, especially among minority communities. Dr. Ulrich Simmons of Advent Health, himself African American, understands that concern.
Heard a lot of things around the trust of the community, particularly those who are African American and Latinx, who have longstanding memories of atrocities that have been committed.
But Dr. Simmons says the vaccine is safe and effective, and you're putting your life in danger each day you hesitate to get vaccinated. President Joe Biden is reportedly considering former U.S. Senator Bill Nelson of Florida to lead NASA. The former head of the space agency, Jim Bridenstine, stepped down as Biden took office. The families of the victims of the 2019 Naval Air Station Pensacola shooting claim the gunman was a Trojan horse sent by Saudi Arabia. That allegation is part of a federal lawsuit filed on behalf of 16 people, including three sailors killed in the attack. Gas prices in Florida are up 15 cents this week compared to last, the highest they've been in over a year.
There's a good chance that we could even see another hike this week of a few cents, maybe even up to 5 cents. It's hard to say.
AAA's Mark Jenkins, that's because of refinery outages in Texas caused by the winter freeze. Ford Motor Company has issued a safety compliance recall for 79,017 vehicles in the U.S. for windshield adhesion. Ford says that affected vehicles do not comply with federal motor vehicle safety standards. The front windshields are inadequately bonded to the vehicle body structure. Ford says in the event of a crash, the windshield may not adequately stay in place, increasing the risk of injury. These include the 2021 Ford F-150 vehicles that were built at Dearborn Truck Plant from October 27, 2020 to February 3, 2021, and the 2021 Ford Super Duty vehicles built at Kentucky Truck Plant October 13 of 2020 to January 23, 2021. Ford says it is not aware of any accidents or injuries related to this condition, and owner notifications will begin the week of April 6. Dealers will remove and reinstall the windshield using standard service procedures. And lastly, the fried chicken wars that started in late 2019 are back. Taco Bell is now throwing their hat in the ring. They just introduced a new fried chicken taco. It's a fried chicken breast wrapped in a puffy piece of flatbread with a chipotle sauce. For now, they're only available in Nashville and Charlotte, but just wait. They're going to roll out nationwide a little bit later this year. In the NBA, the Miami Heat topped the Thunder 108-94 at Oklahoma City. The Orlando Magic are on a roll. They're going to be aiming for a fourth straight win tonight when they host the Detroit Pistons. Newstime 826. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
If you incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24-7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, se habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
Hey, 27 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, on our highways right now, Evan, we're not finding any accidents to report. We have a clear ride north and southbound on our major highways. Of course, US 1 looking good right here in Stuart, all the way on up to the Fort Pierce area right now. And there's your latest look at traffic. And in Port St. Lucie, it's a partly cloudy sky. We're at 69. And in Cold Spring, New York this morning, it's a partly cloudy 34. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
Happy Tuesday sunshine. Waking up this morning to temperatures in the mid-60s. Some isolated rainfall for the morning drive, then clearing conditions through this afternoon with highs in the mid-70s. Tonight, cooler weather makes a return. Lows in the upper 50s, mostly clear skies and some patchy fog. Tomorrow, highs in the mid-70s, mostly sunny skies and a 20% chance for late-day showers. Wednesday into the end of the work week, morning lows in the mid-60s, highs in the low 80s, plenty of sunshine and low rain chances. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
So, have you heard this one? A priest and a rabbi come into this radio station. Really, it's a priest and a rabbi. Right here, Friday mornings beginning at 9, here on WSTU, AM 1450. Bring your questions and join their lively conversation with Father Christian from St. Mary's Episcopal Church and Rabbi Matt Durbin from the Temple Beit Hayim. It's a priest and a rabbi, Friday mornings at 9, here on WSTU.
It's only here but once a year. It's Girl Scout cookie season. Once per year for over 108 years. Girl Scouts all over the USA sell cookies. The sale is just 3.5 weeks long, so buy them while you can. Sale ends March 21st.
Not only are Girl Scout cookies delicious, but by buying Girl Scout cookies, you're supporting local community projects. Last year alone, we made Christmas cards for isolated seniors, we put hygiene kits together for homeless veterans, we gave doggy baths at a local rescue, and we put Christmas stockings together for hundreds of foster kids. We also thanked our local hometown heroes with cookies and cards.
Our troop will be hosting a drive-through cookie booth at the First Congregational Church of God in Port St. Lucie, 4 days a week throughout the sale. But not to worry, you can find a cookie booth by just downloading our Cookie Finder app.
So what can a Girl Scout cookie do?
So much more than what you can see. Buy Girl Scout cookies.
Hi, this is Denny Artachi, host of the Today with Denny show, where we talk about financial and healthy well-being from a common sense perspective. This is a show where we cover what's on your mind, like local, world, and entertainment news. So tune in, have fun, share your story Thursday mornings from 9 to 10 a.m. on WSTU 1450 AM radio.
You're listening to the biggest little radio show on the biggest little planet, the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie.
8:31, the time right now on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie, and it's time for our daily dose of space in another place with the one and only Randy Segal. Good morning, Randy.
Good morning to you, sir. Well, on this date in history, and back in 1990, NASA's spacecraft Pioneer 11 left our solar system to take a look at the interstellar space in between. Highly successful mission that ended in 1974. Ended in 1995. Also, on this day in history, in 1997, the oxygen-generating system on the Russian Mir space station caught fire. And the astronauts were lucky to be able to put that fire out in that spacecraft. There were several astronauts on board, but there were no injuries. Well, on the International Space Station yesterday, it was, come on and get me out of here. Well, that's because the Cygnus spacecraft is docked to the International Space Station, and all those goodies have to be ready and pulled out of the station before Cygnus has a fiery reentry into the Earth's atmosphere. So far, everything is really looking good. They have brought up a cadre of experiments that will help the scientists learn more about what's going on. There's a new vision testing equipment. There's a new computer, a supercomputer, if you will, that was moved to the space station. And the astronauts are investigating, using a lot of different tools, to get ready for the Artemis mission that will take us back to the moon. Coming up is a Soyuz spacecraft mission that is kind of different from any others. The Soyuz will be moved from one location on the International Space Station to another location on the space station in order to be able to pull out the Poisic docking module. This module will no longer be needed, as the Russians will be launching their new science module in place of the peers. So far, everything is going well in preparation for that to take place. It should be around the 19th that we see the redocking taking place, and in April, they will get rid of one of the sections before they bring on board a newer one. Well, they say that everything old is new again, and that may be what happens with NASA's administrator. There's a lot of talk that former U.S. Senator Bill Nelson, who flew into space himself while he was a member of Congress, or was the Senate, excuse me, is being talked about as being NASA's new administrator. He's very close with President Biden, and it would also help with killing several birds with one stone, if you will. The strong relationship with the president, having congressional savvy, puts Bill Nelson in a great position, and Pam Melroy, a former astronaut, is said to be on deck to be his deputy. Well, when you consider the two of them, one with congressional ties and the other one with technical skills, it could be a great combination to lead NASA. We should know, I would say, within the next several weeks or sooner. The Integrity, Mars helicopter aboard the Perseverance rover, has sent back its first status check, and everything is, as they say in space, A-OK. It appears that Ingenuity, while it is still in the belly of Perseverance, it is fully charged, and they're seeing the capabilities of it. They want to make sure that the helicopter's batteries will remain charged on its own solar panel. But thus far, everything looks really good from what we've seen from Percy on Mars. Percy has sent back phenomenal pictures that we've never seen before in real time, showing its landing on the red planet. This is rather unprecedented, and if you haven't seen it yet, go to NASA.gov, and you'll be amazed by these pictures that were sent back. Israel has launched a research nanosatellite into space from the Cygnus module. Cygnus carried a bunch of satellites, mini satellites, if you will, into orbit. Well, Israel, their satellite, is to measure radiation in space. So far, everything has gone well during that mission. Korea is getting ready to launch their own indigenous spacecraft. The Korean government has put together the whole entire rocket without the help of any other country. They're saying that the 475-ton liquid engines in the first stage booster will be able to launch 1.5 tons into low Earth orbit. This should happen within the next, 6 months, if all goes well. So we wish Korea a lot of success. In a rather interesting report that came out on the government, it appears that the youngest workforce of civil servants is with NASA. And the average age, 46.5 years. So NASA is in a great position in the future to have some great scientists and engineers on board. But Chinese spacecraft, Yeotu, that is on the moon, is traveling at a relatively slow rate, but it has already accomplished a drive of 2,164 feet. So you can see that even though the Chinese rover is on the far side of the moon and it only works for 2 weeks, It certainly is getting a lot of exercise and sending back a lot of great data. American scientists will help set up a microscope inside the ISS Russian segment, the Zvezda, in order to be certain that they have found where that leak is coming from. They have sealed the area where they believe the leak has taken place, and it appears that there is very, very minor leaking still going on. A repair kit has been sent to the International Space Station, and the astronauts hopefully will be able to get this completely in hand. The Soyuz TM-29 crew has answered questions from French and Slovak schoolchildren. That crew was launched 22 years ago, but they are still in demand for people who want to learn more about what went on in space. Viktor Afanasyev, Jean-Paul Higner, and Ivan Bella have been having conferences telling school children about their experience. Tomorrow we'll tell you more about NASA, as well as China preparing for an EVA in their space station. So until tomorrow, have a great day, everybody.
Thank you very much. That's Randy Segal with the Space Report. He's on the program each and every weekday at this time, every single day, Monday through Friday, giving us the latest and greatest on what's happening, all things NASA. Time to head on over to Ellie's Downtown Deli, where Bonnie is standing by with the latest and greatest to soothe any hungry male or female's appetite.
That's right, Evan. And if you have a huge appetite today, get ready to enjoy a bacon chicken ranch wrap. It's one of the fresh jumbo wraps that Mark is preparing. It has bacon, chicken, ranch dressing inside with lettuce, tomato, and cheddar in your choice of a wrap. And this is a very mouth-watering one. Have one with a side of some cool, delicious, fluffy potato salad, or a side of black and green olives today, or delight in some dessert like some Oreo pie, and take home a half pound of Mark's delicious fresh chocolate chip cookies. Ellie's Downtown Deli in Stuart now has their patio back open, plus they're at 50% dining inside with a full menu for pickup or delivery. Ellie's also has full dinners available for takeout, plus their fabulous desserts as well. Call 772-781-6605 to order and pick up today. They're located at 18 Southeast 6th Street, just off Colorado and Stuart. Call 772-781-6605. Ellie's Downtown Deli and Stuart.
8:41 news time on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. Go see our good friend Hawk Levy at St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin for the best deals in town. Bonnie?
Thanks, Evan. A boat in St. Lucie County overturned, sending two pregnant women and six men from Cuba overboard on Sunday after more than 16 days at sea on the makeshift vessel made of foam, metal rods, and a Kia car engine, officials and eyewitnesses said. Rescue workers took at least six people to hospitals after everyone had been pulled to shore near Waveland Beach. And St. Lucie and Martin County rescue team officials confirmed this. St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office officials said Monday Department of Homeland Security and U.S. Immigration Reinforcement agents were holding the men and women. Around 6:45 p.m. on Sunday, St. Lucie County Fire District went to the beach after a caller to 911 reported an overturned raft. Martin County Fire Rescue also went just after 7 p.m. and took one person to a hospital who a spokesperson, Bethany Alex, said was in moderate to critical condition at the time. Video taken by a Martin County Sheriff's Office helicopter shows the boat as it gets tossed and overturned by waves with passengers huddled in their jackets and their main coats. The footage shows the overturned boat floating near shore and at least one person being carried out of the water. A top official and the mayor of one of Florida's largest cities say they will disregard Governor Ron DeSantis's order to lower flags to half staff in honor of the late talk show host Rush Limbaugh.
State Agriculture Commissioner Nikki Fried says lowering the flag to half staff is a sacred honor that pays respect to those she calls fallen heroes and patriots. As a result, she's ordering all state offices under her direction to ignore the governor's order, saying the state will not celebrate hate speech, bigotry, and division. Meanwhile, St. Pete Mayor Rick Kreisman says he won't lower the flag for Limbaugh either, saying the city won't honor racism, homophobia, or anything else he's spewed over the years. Kreisman says the city will, however, honor the life of Pinellas County Sheriff's Deputy Michael Magley, who was killed in the line of duty last week. I'm Reed Shepard.
A Treasure Coast man is proving it's never too late to chase a dream. WPTV's Megan McRoberts has the story.
Thank you for your patience.
In the comfort of his Stewart home, 88-year-old Felix Taborda, with his wife Laura by his side.
So I'm going to ask you to please raise your right hand.
Takes his oath of allegiance to become a United States citizen.
That I will support.
A moment nearly a decade in the making. Felix and Laura flew to the United States in 2013 upon the pleading of their children living in the U.S., fleeing Venezuela during a time of violent political unrest.
We decided to stay here, to live here, and our country is very, very hard to live in the condition the government they have right now.
Seeking safety and a better life. Despite both being well-educated with important jobs, Felix, a college professor with a Ph.D.
The salary is $6 per month.
Felix knows the United States is still a beacon of hope for many immigrants like him, wanting to call their home a place with shared values.
I like democracy.
Freedom.
When a social worker with Treasure Coast Hospice learned that even at his late age, Felix still had set his sights on citizenship, she helped write letters, submit medical documents, helping secure Felix an unusual chance to take a citizenship test at home, as he is in hospice care with stage 4 colon cancer.
So help me God.
Yeah.
Okay, congratulations.
To now share in citizenship with his wife, who took her oath last year.
Okay, awesome.
Giving them comfort they'll spend the rest of their years together with family and no threat of separation.
We're all together.
Megan McRoberts, WPTV, News Channel 5.
And lastly, SpaceX is planning to launch its first all-civilian flight this fall, and a 29-year-old woman who beat cancer as a kid just got a free ticket. Her name is Haley Arsenault, and she was a patient at St. Jude's 2 decades ago and now works there as a physician assistant. A billionaire named Jared Isaacman is paying for her seat, and you could also win one by donating at least $10 to St. Jude's by this Sunday. Only 19 of the 32 NFL teams permitted fans inside their stadiums last season, and those that did only had a fraction of the fans they usually have. So how did that affect home field advantage? Well, it destroyed it. Home teams had a losing record in 2020, making it the first season in modern NFL history where home teams didn't post a winning record. That said, in a coincidental twist, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers also became the first team to play and win a Super Bowl on their home field. Our news time, 8:47. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancée means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
.848 the time right now, the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Waterway Dermatology. Dr. Ryan Shearing, located at 1050 Monterey Road in Stuart, bringing personalized health care back to dermatology the Waterway. Bonnie?
Getting on out to work on your Tuesday morning, it's really a nice clear ride. We don't have any accidents, and this including U.S. Highway 1, looking good north and southbound, and so are major highways, no tie-ups, no accidents, and there's your latest look at traffic. And it's 70 this morning in Stuart. In Paracas, Peru, it's 72. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
Happy Tuesday sunshines. Waking up this morning to temperatures in the mid-60s. Some isolated rainfall for the morning drive, then clearing conditions through this afternoon with highs in the mid-70s. Tonight, cooler weather makes a return, lows in the upper 50s, mostly clear skies and some patchy fog. Tomorrow, highs in the mid-70s, mostly sunny skies and a 20% chance for late-day showers. Wednesday into the end of the work week, morning lows in the mid-60s, highs in the low 80s, plenty of sunshine and low rain chances.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Dermatology is now open in Stuart, a new independently owned dermatology practice with Dr. Ryan Shearing, board certified for your medical or cosmetic skincare needs. Office hours 9 to 5 Monday through Saturday with extended hours from 9 to 7 on Thursdays. Serving Martin and St. Lucie counties in the Monterey Triangle Building, US 1 and Monterey Road, Stuart. Waterway Dermatology, bringing personalized health care back to dermatology the Waterway. Book a consultation at waterwayderm.com or call 561-926-6150 for Waterway Dermatology.
What is your quality of life? The Owen Insurance Group plans on improving it on our Quality of Life radio show Tuesday mornings at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU. Hi, I'm Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group, along with Tom Bouvier. We'll help you on the road of life and make it a better one. Don't forget the Quality of Life radio show, Tuesdays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU on TuneIn and Alexa.
With any business, the most valuable asset are the people and the teams, no matter how small or large the organization. Hi, I'm Catherine Cohane, Associate Director for the Florida SBDC at Indian River State College. Let us help your organization turbocharge your team. As a certified driving forces analyst, I will help management work more effectively with your people, increase and improve communication, reduce conflict and stress, better understand strengths and weaknesses so that your people are properly aligned in their jobs. Hire the right people. Let the Florida SBDC at IRSC transform your company using a customized assessment system, knowledge, and resources. Grow and accelerate your organization by turbocharging your team. To get started, contact the Florida SBDC at IRSC.
For confidential one-on-one business consulting at no cost, contact the Florida SBDC at IRSC at 336-6285. Online at irscbiz.com.
Hi, this is Denny Artachi, host of the Today with Denny show, where we talk about financial and healthy well-being from a common sense perspective. This is a show where we cover what's on your mind, like local, world, and entertainment news. So tune in, have fun, share your story Thursday mornings from 9 to 10 a.m. on WSTU 1450 AM radio.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to wstumorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
Hi, folks. It's me, Mike Lindell from MyPillow. You know I love MyPillow, and now I have a new venture, my lawsuit. Let me hug this pillow while I tell you that I'm being sued for $1.3 billion from a voting machine company. This comfortable pillow sells for $50 each, meaning I must sell 23 million of these pillows to have all that money. And my pillows are made right here in Minnesota from a staff who just texted me today, STFU. I don't know what that means, but maybe it stands for So Tough Fighting Unified. So help me, Mike Swindell, I mean Lindell, with ordering your My Pillow today.
My Pillow. Poor guy. Poor guy.
I haven't seen one of those My Pillow commercials in a while. I don't know if I'm watching a different channel in the morning.
Oh, they're out there.
Yeah.
They're definitely out there.
It used to be every morning I couldn't step out the door without finding one.
Yeah.
And I like how they go back to the history of building the pillows in the factory up there in Minnesota in the old days. And of course, I've never bought a My Pillow before.
Yeah.
I've talked to people who have purchased them and spent money on them.
So, Bonnie, I came across a couple of top five lists I wanted to go over with you. I think you'll find this one a little humorous. It's the top five things that former President Donald Trump enjoys doing in his newfound spare time.
Ah, okay.
Okay, and coming in at number five, he hires people to fire people for the people he just hired. Okay.
Okay, hiring people.
Yeah, hiring people.
To fire people
for the people he just hired.
That's really keeping busy, I guess.
Coming in at number four, looks for a landfill to buy so he can own a Trump dump. Okay. Coming in at number three, calling up Donald Duck and saying, I am the Donald.
I am the one and only Donald.
I'm the one and only Donald. Coming in at number two, hiring someone to go bowling for him.
Oh.
Okay. And coming in at number one.
Virtual bowling.
Yeah. Coming in at number one on the list of top things that Donald Trump enjoys doing in his newfound spare time, having a beautiful woman run her fingers through his hair while he's out playing golf.
Wow.
Total decadence.
I wonder how much he would be paying that beautiful woman to run the fingers through Donald's hair.
I have no idea. No idea at all. But we do have a phone call right now, so let's take our phone call. Good morning. You're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Who's this?
Yeah, man.
Hey, Fredo. How are you?
I'm glad you brought up pillows because I want to talk about Fredo's My Pillow. Yeah, man.
Oh, you have a My Pillow service?
Yeah, man. It's pillows I slept on. That's right. Pillows are slept on. That's why it's called My Pillow. Yeah, man.
Oh, tell us more, please.
Well, it has my wonderful scent of my cologne.
Oh.
Yeah, man.
Oh.
Right on there. And then when the lady puts her head down, she thinks she's sleeping with me. Yeah, man, right there.
Oh, wow. So it's My Pillow by Fredo.
Well, she runs her fingers through Fredo's hair.
Fredo's hair, yes.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
And that's what it's called, My Pillow, because I've already slept on it.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
Now, have you gone into manufacturing Fredo's all-new My Pillow yet?
Oh, I just go to, like, Bed Bath & Beyond, buy a pillow, I sleep on it, then I send it out. Yeah, man, that's what I do.
What?
Wow.
Are you serious?
That's what's called My Pillow. Yeah, man.
You know what, Fredo? What you need to sell these, though, is a good marketing name. You always need that name.
Yeah, you need a good marketing name besides just My Pillow.
I have one for you.
All right, what is it,
Bonnie? For marketing performance, just call it Fredo's Bedhead.
Oh, I like that.
Fredo's.
Ooh, I like that.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, Bonnie's going to get a cut now. Yeah, man.
How much of a percentage are you, Bonnie?
She gets free feet massages for about a month. Yeah,
okay.
Man.
Well, Bonnie, you need to go online and patent that real quick. You need to go to the copyright division and register that name real quick before Fredo does.
Right. We need one for
Fredo's
that one.
Fredo's Bedhead Pillow.
Yeah, man.
Okay. All right.
That's cool. I mean, very powerful, isn't it? I think it'll sink in with a lot of people, and they'll want to try it.
Yeah, I think it will. I definitely think
maybe
it will. Sure, why not? What the heck?
I'm going to send one to Evan. I already got one in the mail for you. Yeah, man.
Oh, well,
I just
thank you.
It out.
I appreciate that. I appreciate that very
man.
Much.
Yeah, man, makes you think you're all cuddled up next to the Fredo. Yeah,
oh,
man.
Geez. Oh. Something I just always want to do is just cuddle up next to Fredo.
Do you think you'll start a whole factory of them like John Lindell did?
Yeah.
I might just go buy a bunch of them, sleep on it, and then send it on out. Yeah, man.
Are you going to set up a roadside stand?
That's a good idea. Yeah, man. I might just do that. Get a trailer up. Hold on. Get that trailer going. We're going to sell some pillows on the side of the road. Yeah, man.
Oh, jeez. Oh, my God.
Yeah,
all right. Well, you go sell your My Pillows or Bedhead Pillows, and we're going to get out of here because we're just about done with the show.
I got to make sure I use Big Kid as much as I can. She's going to Vegas tomorrow. Yeah, man.
Oh, okay. All right. Say goodnight. Say goodnight, Fredo.
Yeah, man.
All right. That's Fredo, our fearless band leader, who checks in from time to time every now and then with us.
Well, that's our show.
It's over.
What?
It's over. It is over.
Is that it?
That's it.
Everybody still awake?
Will you come on already? I just can't stand these long goodbyes.
All right. Big finish.
See you later.
That's right. We say see you later because that's a wrap for Tuesday, Bonnie.
Yeah, we'll just see you, I guess, in another 21 hours. Yes.
Yeah, we'll be back. It's the Hump Day edition tomorrow right here. Biggest little radio show on the face of the planet. Award-winning, critically acclaimed Get Up and Go show.
It is Hump Day tomorrow. It doesn't feel like it already.
It is.
But it's good.
It truly is. Just remember one thing, folks. We say this every day, and we stand by it. If you have good values on the inside, you won't look for validation on the outside. We have a lot of love in this room, and Bonnie and I, we send it right back out to everybody.
Yep. Take special care.
Have a great day, folks. We're WSTU Stewart. We're Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next. Don't go anywhere. See you tomorrow morning. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.